Stadium, the Panthers will host the 16th-ranked Nittany Lions of Penn State. Hi again, everybody. I'm Jim Kelly, and welcome to the 87th renewal of this great rivalry between Pittsburgh and Penn State, rivalry that goes way back to 1893. Their annual battle for a cut of the Commonwealth, if you will, so important as far as national rankings, important as far as the bowl bids are concerned, and certainly important to both Pittsburgh and Penn State as far as recruiting within the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. As always, our expert analyst, Kevin Kiley, is alongside. And Kevin, when you talk about Joe Paterno, two national championships, he does it with good linebackers and a great defense.
Well, Jim, offense has not exactly been a priority over the years at Penn State. Joe Paterno's philosophy has been to put the best players on defense, put together a strong kicking game, and away we go. But this season, injuries have crippled his defense, and they're now, just now, getting healthy. In fact, in Game 10, it'll be the first time his four senior linebackers, Karpinski and Bowron, Giftopoulos and Vernier, have started a game together. And in fact, they'll have a heck of a time tonight chasing around one of the great quarterbacks, freshman quarterbacks in the country.
Darnell Dickerson, the man Kevin is talking about, he runs like a gazelle. He's got a howitzer for an arm, but he's only played seven quarters so far for Pitt.
Well, they've had some problems offensively. Mike Gottfried's philosophy offensively is to open it up, but he felt earlier he just didn't have the horses, and that's why two games ago he went to the young freshman Darnell Dickerson. And what Dickerson does for the Pitt offense, he can get to the corner. He's a great athlete, a tremendous runner. He's got a cannon for an arm. He lacks a little bit of experience, but he'll take him sideline to sideline. He'll open up that inside running game for the nation's leading rusher, Craig Hayward.
Cannot do is run the wishbone very well. They tried it back in the spring, and they tried Zeke Gadsden at fullback in the wishbone. Didn't work. But now Gadsden is an All-America candidate at linebacker.
Ezekiel wasn't a very good third-string fullback, but he's one heck of a first-string outside linebacker. 21 and a half sacks so far this year. Penn State, a key for their offense. Keep Zeke Gadsden out of the backfield, and they will have some success.
How big a game is it? Joe Paterno excited, took his troops out onto the field early. He's ready. He has won. He's never lost here at Pitt Stadium. And now Mike Gottfried in his second season, getting ready for this huge game before another sellout crowd, getting ready to bring his Panthers. Here they come out of the tunnel. ESPN's presentation of CFA football is being brought to you by Casio Pulse and DataVac Watches. Casio, where miracles never cease. By the makers of the CFA VCR College Bowl Game. By Budweiser, Beechwood Age, for that clean, crisp taste, this Bud's for you. And by Computerland, the one thing to know about computers.
Introducing the G-Shock 5200 watch from Casio. The sports watch that's ready for action with a built-in shock absorber. It's tough. So tough, this G-Shock can take a slap in the face. And not even flinch. The G-Shock 5200, just one of Casio's water-resistant sports watches. It's one tough watch to beat.
Two great college football coaches come together for another great game.
Barry, I think we should punt.
No, let's go for it.
Enjoy the thrill of real college football action.
Oh, it's your ball, Johnson.
With the VCR College Bowl Game. Punt, go for a field goal, score the winning touchdown. You can do it all.
It's a touchdown.
Look for VCR College Bowl football wherever games are sold. Also look for VCR top-ranked boxing game, the brand new game that puts you center ring for some of the greatest matches in boxing history.
In communities across America, there's a working spirit. People working together with a feeling of pride. When that feeling exists, there's Dickies Work Clothes. America, it still works. Dickies, the brand it works in. Dickies, made with Celanese Fortrel polyester.
Ahem. As president of Loomis and Brunswick, I recommend that we buy a computer at Computerland.
But as chairman, I must consider our frugal fiscal policy.
As comptroller, I'm sure we'll be very fiscal and save money, too.
Well, as personnel director, I'd like to know who the heck is going to teach us to use it, and if it breaks down, who'll fix it?
Well, as research director, I found the answer to both.
Yeah?
It's Computerland.
Okay, let's call Computerland. Where's that secretary?
It's your turn.
I know that.
There is the Panthers head coach, Mike Gottfried. His team is 6-3 this year. They lost out to Penn State last year, 34-14. And just seconds ago, his pregame talk to his troops.
And tonight we get an opportunity in front of the nation's audience again to go out in a great crowd out here, a great home crowd that's been out here for a long time, chanting and cheering, to again take the pride of our program. When you leave that door tonight, I'm going to tell you something. You represent a great university in football that has put it on the line a long time. And what you need to do is do your part tonight. There's no doubt in my mind we're going to win the football game. Whatever happens in this ball game is to stay on course. Offensively, that's just every play. Take a little bit out of them. Every play is moving football. Defensively, alert the whole way. Special teams alert. We're getting better in all those areas. We talked, we had goals at the beginning of the year, and remember those goals. And we're knocking them off one by one. And tonight we get a chance to knock another one off there. So let's all do our part out there. I tell you, let's have fun. I'm telling you right now, let's don't go out there tight. Let's just go out and have the best.
Mike and the Panthers allowing our ESPN camera and microphones in for that private chat. And there he is, Mike Gottfried, 11 victories, 8 losses, 1 tie in his second year. There is Jeff Van Horn, the sophomore out of Cheyenne, Washington. He's 5'9", he's got a great leg, and back deep for the Penn State Nittany Lions. There's number 44, Leroy Thompson. He averages just under 25 yards on the kickoff returns. And over on the lower right-hand side of your screen, there is Gary Brown, who averages about 19 yards on his kickoff returns. So it is the 87th renewal. This rivalry goes way back to 1893, 63 of the 86 games played here in Pittsburgh. The battle for a cut of the Commonwealth, a sellout crowd, and we are underway. End over end. At the three, it's Gary Brown, a convoy in front of him. And at the 17-yard line, Brown is upended. Let's meet the Penn State Nittany Lions after that 15-yard kickoff return.
Quarterback Matt Kizner, they run a very conservative offense. He may be able to do more than they really ask him to do. Green is the fullback, Blair Thomas, one of the best offensive backs in the entire country. Michael Timpson, a speed burner, a track guy. Alexander has improved over the past 2 weeks. A very fine offensive line. Sickler been a starter all year. Freeman stepped in because of injury. The front three, excellent. Wisniewski made the best of that three.
Backs are split. Goes to Blair Thomas, who is tripped up by Jerry Osofsky, the middle defensive linebacker. Let's check now that Pitt Panther defense.
Well, as good a front four as you'll find in the country. Spindler, of course, a high school freshman. Syracuse playing with a little banged up knee. Carter, the captain of the team. Grossman has 5 sacks. He leads that defensive front. Linebackers are excellent. Osofsky, he calls the signals. Gatson, the big play guy, 21.5 sacks. Defensive cornerbacks are tough. Richard playing a little bit banged up tonight. Jones, a good one. Owens, maybe an All-American. They're solid.
Timpson, wide left at the bottom of your screen. Double tight end. Humphrey, 88. Marasco, 89. Quick hitter. Not much doing. Up front for Johnny Green out of Youngstown, Ohio, the senior. John Carter, the senior right defensive end, and Jerry Wall on the stop defensively for Pitt.
The Penn State people felt that they could go right at Mark Spindler, and one of the reasons, he's a freshman and he gets high. See, if his hat is higher than the offensive player, he's too high. See how he gets turned around and spun down? He needs to learn as a freshman. Even though he's got the size, he's got to stay low. On the goal line, that could be devastating, and we'll follow it for you tonight.
There's Kitchener on 3rd and 6. Alexander and Timpson wide at the top of your screen. Panthers showing blitz, and here they come. Kisner with the dancing feet. Penalty flag is down. Timpson pulls, and it's at the 25-yard line. Stacked up shy of first down yardage. Osofsky, the junior out of Youngstown, on the stop. Time is out with 13:24 left, and there's a flag to be checked out. Holding against Penn State. So Kisner was stopped way shy of first down yardage, had to get it up near the 27-yard line. Let's see if we can pick up the penalty now. Maybe Tim Freeman, the junior out of Virginia Beach, right side of the screen. Watch number 71 in white.
Well, Jimmy, Penn State is the type of team that does not like to get into situations. They need big yardage on first and second down. They don't want to get into a passing situation, and that's why. You see Freeman holding him. They don't like to be predictable. Zeke Catson did a great job on that play covering a tight end all the way across the field. That's who they wanted to go to. Kisner couldn't find him. And Pittsburgh was able to hold Penn State.
Chris Klaus and back deep Terrell Austin. Averaging about 8 yards on his punt returns. Panthers should come out of this with good field position. A line drive. Austin moves up to the 38. Explodes to the 45. Approaches midfield. And is hammered backwards at the 47-yard line. Here come the Panthers of Mike Godfrey.
Darnell Dickerson, not a finished product yet, but he's got all the tools, the feet and the arm and just about everything. He's a good player. Craig Hayward, the leading rusher in the nation, all of 275 pounds. Vernon Kirk at tight end will be starting his first game. Reggie Williams, the leading receiver for this team. And Tom Ricketts, a guy who has to block a little differently for Darnell Dickerson. Roman Matus having a big year. Middle three, excellent. Stepnowski and Calaguire having big years.
With the aggressive linebacking core of Penn State, they expect Hayward on a counter all night. They open up with a counter. Penn State stayed in their lanes, and Trey Bauer, the leading tackler, the senior out of Paramus, New Jersey, on the initial hit. Here come the Penn State defenders.
A difficult team to fool. Kirkendall is a great player, just a super pass rusher, the best of the front three. The linebackers, we talked about them in the open, Karpinski and Bernier, they've all been injured this year. Bauer, the leading tackler, Giftopoulos playing with a broken hand, a defensive secondary banged up, Downing in place of the starter, Wilkerson starting, but good players, all of them, very solid.
Osborne and Williams wide to the right. Panthers looking at second down and nine. Darnell Dickerson, the freshman on a sprint out, will pull it down. Across the midfield stripe, out of bounds at the 49-yard line of Penn State. Brian Chismar, the sophomore out of Pittsburgh, bumped him out.
This is what Dickerson can do for you now. He's the back that's uncovered. You see the action going? A lot of blocking on the corner. Watch the blocking and the hook block on the corner. And now Dickerson, he can fly. 6'4", long legs, and he can run. And they will ask him to run all night. That'll put a lot of pressure on the Penn State defense.
There is an exciting young man. He has only played 7 quarters so far for Mike Godfrey. Mike said he tried for about 5 games to get him into the lineup. Went with the experience of Sal Janella, finally made the change, and the youngster has responded. Third and four. Delay to Riddick. Riddick, first down at the 43-yard line of Penn State.
One of the things you do against a very big, tough, aggressive front is your cross block. Watch the left side. 64, Calaguire, and number 71, Ricketts, cross block. They develop an angle, and bang, Riddick right up through the middle for a first down. Here's your inside linebacker. See how they react. See how Ricketts comes out. He's able to pick up the linebacker, Bauer, and it's a first down.
Dickerson's first pass. You'll see his arm. Safety valves it out. Gets it to Riddick. Back at the line of scrimmage. Second down and 10 coming up. Scott Gobb, the junior out of Pittsburgh, on the stop.
Conspicuous by his absence, Craig Hayward. He has not run the ball yet, and that's because of this guy, Darnell Dickerson. They want him to handle the ball early. He's just a freshman, first time against Penn State. They want him to get his confidence. But you'll see plenty of Hayward before this game's over. Number 34. You can't miss him. He's a semi. There he is.
Henry Tootin out wide to the right at the bottom of the screen. Michael Stewart wide left. Dickerson, they fake the reverse. Darnell pulls it down. He's out of bounds at the 41-yard line.
Good job by Penn State. They are so well coached, Penn State. You can fool them for a while, but in the end, you're just going to have to play good, solid football against the Nittany Lions. This is a defense that pretty much won the national title last year, coached by that man, Joe Paterno. You know, against the Miami team, when you hold them to 10 points, you're doing pretty well. Last year in the national title game.
Third and nine, slot to the left. Williams, Osborne, Hosea Hurd, bottom of the screen. Dickerson going there. Fires, caught at the 31. Was he inbounds? He was. Reggie Williams on a comeback. Willie Thomas, the freshman, spun around on the coverage. A 10-yard pickup. They needed nine.
They say this guy's a runner, but they also say he's a good drop-back passer. He doesn't have happy feet. He will jump around in the pocket, and here's an example of it.
Dickerson, young man, just standing there, and then the rifle arm. Reggie Williams coming in, averaging almost 17 yards a catch. He's a good receiver, makes the fine catch, keeps his legs in bounds.
Dickerson came in 16 of 42. He's 2 for 2 on the night for 16 yards. He's thrown 1 touchdown, 2 interceptions. Out of the eye, pro set. Hayward the tailback. It goes to Riddick, the fullback. Hammers ahead behind the blocking up front of Miller, Caliguire, and Stefanski. Picks up 3, second down and 7. Never lost at Pitt Stadium. Osborne wide to the left. Eric Seaman, Vernon Kirk as they go with a double tight end on 2nd and 7. Dickerson batted down at the 25 by Keith Karpinski. Karpinski, 6'4", 222, the senior out of Hamtramck, Michigan.
But make no mistake about it, when these linebackers play together, they're as good as any unit in the country, and Karpinski is one of the best of the four. Great reactions. They know how to read offenses. They know even what's going on behind them without even turning around, just by looking at the flow. Karpinski getting his arm up and doing the job.
And Kevin, if there's a rap against Dickerson, in addition to inexperience, it might be that he tries to force because he does have that great gun. That one was batted up in the air and almost intercepted. Intended for Hayward. Karpinski deflected the ball and actually had a shot to come up with the interception.
It's recognition, Jim. When you play linebacker, you feel things. And Karpinski felt the last one. Watch him feel this. He knows there's a back out there, and he can just feel it. See him starting to drift, and then he doesn't come at the quarterback because he knows there's a back out there. It was Hayward. He gets up, uses that 6'4 frame of his to knock it down. That's instinct, folks. You can't coach that.
A 44-yard try, Van Horn, as you see. 3 out of 7 from that distance. His longest, 52 yards. Second, his longest is 47. Osborne puts it down on its way. It's good. A 44-yarder by Jeff Van Horn, the sophomore. He's only 5'9". So the Pitt Panthers get 3 on their initial possession.
Over the past few years, Chevrolet has made a few changes. We've given you the Instatrack 4x4 system, turbos to go quicker, an anti-lock brake system, and the highest mileage car in the country. So now Chevrolets are even more fun to drive, and so dependable they have a 660 warranty. As for how all those changes have affected Chevrolet, well, we're still America's best-selling cars.
The heartbeat of America.
From all over the world to compete for the Budweiser Breeders' Cup in one of horse racing's most prestigious events, the Breeders' Cup Turf. Witness the excitement as the world's best thoroughbreds compete for the Budweiser Breeders' Cup and a $2 million purse. Budweiser, the king of beers, is proud to sponsor this exciting event. And you can see it all on November 21st as the Breeders' Cup races come to you from Hollywood Park in California. Horse racing fans, this Bud's for you.
CFA football is being brought to you by AC Delco. Stay out of trouble with AC Delco parts. And by the financial professionals at Payne Weber Incorporated.
Go, 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 go.
Spotting the ball, Jeff Van Horn with that 44-yard field goal to put Pittsburgh up 3-0. It was Van Horn that had that 29-yarder against Notre Dame last year to ice that 10-9 Pitt upset over the Irish. There is Van Horn, and back deep. There is Leroy Thompson and Gary Brown coming into your picture now, and it will be Leroy Brown at the 5. Leroy Thompson, check it. Thompson across the 20, down at the 22. A 16-yard return by Leroy Thompson, the scoring drive. There is Jeff Van Horn, the super sophomore, 10 plays, 27 yards, and they used up under 3 minutes. Important, I think, too, that Pittsburgh scored first in this game. You don't want to get behind Penn State by 10, by 7. Not with that linebacking core and that great defense.
Penn State's one of those teams you have to believe that you can beat them, and the only way to do it is to physically overmatch them on the field and get some points. It did that.
Penalty flag is down. Nell Wilson Walker, the right defensive end, jumped off sides. So instead of first and 10, it will be first and 5.
Set ball, left side on the defense, 5 yards, first down.
We talked about it in that first series. The Panthers got Penn State in a third and long situation, and that's what makes this penalty especially harmful. It gives them the opportunity to use their whole offense right away, a first and 5. You need to get Penn State stuffed on first down, second down, given that third long. They're not a great passing team, and you need to put them in passing situations. First down penalties, no good.
Alexander wide to the far side. Timpson comes to the near side. Near the 30-yard line,
Blair Thomas, the ball carrier.
Mark Spindler, the freshman, maybe the most highly recruited freshman last year on the stop.
He's a great athlete, and he's worked his way into the starting lineup. But as we talked about him, he's a kid that will get high. This is typical of a freshman, getting his hat higher. See how he gets his hat higher? See, look at the positioning on the offensive blocker pushing him backwards, and that's because you let him get into your chest. You have got to get your hat down below his.
A short one. Long count. Blitz. Sack. Osaski. He came in with 4.5 sacks. He was a runaway freight train.
He's not big, he's not strong, but he's unquestionably the smartest member of the defense. They don't check off, they don't pick it up. They needed the zone block that and block everybody down. Osaski right through the center and gets Kisner. This is a guy that sat out some of the games. He was injured early in the year, and it was devastating to the Pittsburgh defense. They need him in there. He calls all the signals.
Coaches say that his quickness makes up for his lack of size. He's not a great 50 linebacker. What do they mean by that?
I'll tell you in a minute.
On 3rd and 10, play action fake. Kisner pulls it down, unloads. He's got Johnny Green, loose football. Pittsburgh's got it at the 33. Osaski comes right back. And we just talked about his quickness making up for his lack of size. Jerry Wall, 51, will force the fumble.
This is a great defensive unit. They know exactly where to go and what to do when they get there. Now watch him strip the ball. Gadsden, at great speed, stripping the ball loose on the back. Pressure on Kisner. Kisner's had a rough year, folks, and it's not getting any better. Wall knocking him down and maybe causing a problem, although he did complete the pass. Give him credit for that. That shows you really the linebackers. One linebacker made the hit in the backfield. The other linebacker forced the fumble, and I believe the third linebacker recovered it.
And Kisner very slow to get up after that tremendous hit put on him by number 51, Jerry Wall. This is a little bit reminiscent of when the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame came in. We did that game, and the Panthers rolled up to a quick 28-0 lead. Pittsburgh very poised right now, taking advantage of some penalties, taking advantage of that turnover, and they've got great field position at the 38.
Well, they had some problems offensively, and that can wear on you defensively. When you don't feel your offense can score points, and Pittsburgh's offense stalled a lot early in the year, it can get you down emotionally. They feel differently now, and they're up.
And the eye pro set. Wright and Hayward are the running backs. The tailback, of course, is Ironhead. Dickerson over the middle on the post, wide open. Reggie Williams inside the 5. A 29-yard pickup.
The arm, he's got that strong arm. Puts a little bit of touch on this. Now he's inside the zone, but he's not that open. That's a great throw by Dickerson right in the chest of Williams. And I'll tell you right away, you see a different offense here with Dickerson in here. We've had these guys twice before. Reggie Williams catching the ball, Dickerson throwing it, and they do everything a little quicker.
Working on the pressure from the left cornerback, Willie Thomas. First and goal from the 4. Full on backfield. Dickerson, that looked like a busted play. He looked like he was supposed to hand off, and there was nobody there.
Well, they're showing a wishbone formation because they want to stretch the defense and create a seam. Here you're looking at Bauer from the back, number 35. Dickerson down the line. Bauer just following him. And everybody, Gatopoulos, everybody coming in to get him. Penn State's defense, that 34 with the very active linebackers, is an excellent defense against the wishbone.
Second and goal from the 7. Line to the left, Michael Stewart, the senior out of Norwalk, Ohio. Hayward in the backfield. He's got the ball. And the Nittany Lions have got Ironhead. Keith Karpinski, the left outside linebacker, the senior out of Hamtramck, and Matt Johnson, the senior out of York, Pennsylvania, on the stop.
Penn State will dare you to throw the ball on the goal line. They'll go with a 9-man line, and they'll force, and they'll play gap defense and come after you. Now, the ball is just about in the middle of the field. I would look for Dickerson on this play, some kind of a rollout pass-run option. You've got the mobile quarterback. He's got a gun for an arm. It's a little wider. The left side of the field, I would expect him to roll a little bit left.
Osborne and Williams are slotted out to the left. Blitz. There's the quick feet and the good arm. He'll just throw it away. Pressure by Brian Chismar, the sophomore out of Pittsburgh. And Dickerson, not playing like a freshman right there, Kevin, showed poise. They'll take the field goal.
Well, this is an excellent defensive call, Jim, by the Penn State people, and a good job by Dickerson. Now, this is a dash. This is a set play. They wanted him to go left. They just didn't want to have guys forcing him and not have a chance to throw a decent pass. But you're right. Dickerson unloads the ball well out of bounds, so there's no turnover, and they can still get to 3 points. Good call by Penn State. They will pressure you inside. They gave Maryland fits last week. Maryland got inside their 20 a few times and couldn't get any points.
A 24-yard field goal, hash mark to the right. Van Horn has had problems with a hash mark to the left side, but he did win the West Virginia game from the left hand. On its way. No good. So the Penn State Nittany Lions come in ranked 16th. They fumble the ball. They gave it over the Panthers in good field position and dodged a bullet.
This is the Payne Weber Special Report. Some people are still asking, is this 1929 all over again? The fact is, the differences between 29 and today are far greater than the similarities. Let's get those differences from one of our top experts.
60 years ago, we had a very different market. It was dominated by individuals who tended to buy on very low margin. Today's market, it's dominated by institutions who aren't, by and large, very leveraged. But probably the most important difference today has been the response of the Federal Reserve Board. In 29, they actually raised interest rates. Today's response, quite the difference. They lowered rates, helping to stimulate the economy. We have a problem in Washington with the budget deficit. We've got to deal with it. But for now, the aftermath of the crash of 87, to us, doesn't look like 29. No, not at all.
Thanks, Ed. And goodbye for now. This has been a Payne Weber Special Report.
Every Sunday, the players take notes, and the coaches listen in when Chris Berman, Tom Jackson, and Pete Axthelm deliver the day's most exhaustive coverage of the NFL. Sundays on ESPN.
Another triple header here on ESPN. Coming up next, the Rams of Colorado State, the Aztecs of San Diego State. Kevin, we'll get a chance to see the quarterback, Todd Santos, who last week became the NCAA's all-time leading passer. Greg Papa and Dave Logan standing by to bring you that one at the end of our game. Another triple header here on ESPN. Zeke Gadsden and Matt Kisner. They'll see a lot of each other before this one is through. From the 20. They'll sprint out all kinds of time. Matt can pull it down and will dive for 3 yards in the grasp of Jerry Osaski. Penn State drives, Kevin, have started at their own 17, their own 22, and their own 20.
And they're not getting too far, and that's because they're playing against the eighth-ranked defense in the nation. Here's Osofsky, reading pass, deepening up. Now he knows he's running, and he releases himself, able to chase the play down. Not big, Osofsky, but as I said, a key member of this defense, and very, very smart. He identifies all new formations, lets the other guys know what's going on.
Blair Thomas cracks it over the right side. Blocking by Duffy, Wisniewski, and Freeman. Jerry Wall, the senior, has him there, 6'3", 220.
Back like that, you need to contain him. Pitt did that. They're outside people, got upfield a little bit, and turned him in. They're very concerned with overrunning the play. They had to slow down John Fox was telling us they had to slow down their defensive pursuit during practice, getting ready for Penn State. They didn't want their backside people running too far, getting sealed off, and having Blair Thomas run back to the other side.
Alexander, wide, bottom of your screen. Timpson at the top on third and five. Motion by Timpson. Blair Thomas. What a move. Grossman on the stop.
Another good job by Olsoski. Now that thing should have gone for a first down. Olsoski had no chance to make the tackle, but he took an outside lane, cut off Blair Thomas, made him go back inside where the rest of the defense could catch up. Good team defense.
One of 10 children, Chris Klaus right there. His only punt so far in the night, 38 yards to that man. Terrell Austin, who averages just under, partially blocked. Hits at the 48-yard line and bounds backwards. Finally killed by the Nittany Lions there. Matt Lavinia got a piece of that ball. It's only a 24-yard punt. The Panthers come right back when we come back. Matt Lavinia got a piece of that ball. It's only a 24-yard punt. The Panthers come right back when we come back. Bends in. Ironhead, penalty flag is down. And Kevin, he took three Penn State Nittany Lions with him from midfield for 4 yards.
Well, preseason, Jim, Ironhead was kind of a, I don't know, he was low density iron. He only weighed about 260, but 12 pizzas later, as you see a holding penalty on Pittsburgh, the guy's up to 275 pounds. And when you ask the coaches about it now, they used to talk diets. Now they just shrug their shoulders.
He is amazing, leads the nation in rushing. And you saw a good example of it right there with three Nittany Lions just clinging to him. He dragged them for 4 yards.
That's a big, big penalty against Pitt. That'll really put him in the hole. A holding penalty on first down. Type of thing you can't do against Penn State. You know, Joe Paterno, as I talked about his philosophy in the open, don't make mistakes. And since most mistakes are made offensively, he has a conservative offense, as you can see. Pittsburgh making a mistake puts themselves, starting with great field position, Jim, they go way back on first down now, first and 20.
Coming out wide to the right, Michael Stewart, number 30, out of Norwalk, Ohio. And the slot is Billy Osborne, out of Wildwood Crest, New Jersey. Second and 20 after that Pitt Panther penalty. Saying his knee was down at the 49-yard line.
Strength of arm. Now Stewart only had 8 catches coming into this game, but he wasn't catching them from this guy. Now this is a pretty good zone. The difference is this is a gun. Now this is slow motion, folks, and he's just rifling that ball right into the chest of Michael Stewart. Now these guys' statistics are going to go up. All the receivers' statistics go up, because he can get the ball there in a hurry. It takes the defense a while to adjust to that, too. They're not used to seeing a guy who can rifle a ball that hard.
On the sprint out, Dickerson never wanted to pass. This was a run designed the entire way. Out of bounds at the 47, chased out by Rain.
Well, they did a nice job on Karpinski. Somebody hit him first, and then Craig Hayward came in and finished the job, knocked number 84 right on his back. Extra added dimension. That man, Darnell Dickerson, he can run, take the ball, and run to the sideline. If he ever gets his shoulders turned upfield, he's gone.
He's one of those guys the coaches call an immediate impact player.
Well, they were trying to get him in for about 5 or 6 games. The games were all too close. Mike finally said the heck with it in Syracuse. He put him in, and he's glad he did.
Osborne and Williams wide to the right on third and five. Dickerson, he'll spread out. It's that floating pocket. All day to throw. Nobody's open. Safety valves to Riddick. Riddick dives to the 47. No gain. Trey Bauer on the stop. Senior linebacker out of Paramus. 44 tackles coming in.
Keith Karpinski, now they know they have to contain this guy, so he gets his hands on Riddick, the blocker. See that? Now that's great upper body strength. He's able to stay in front of Dickerson. Dickerson finally just tosses the ball to the guy that was blocking him.
Rasp will hang it high. Coates is back deep. Fair catches at the 12. A 35-yard punt, no return. 3:04 left to go. Penn State held scoreless. Pitt's got three. Of 1 second and 11 coming up. Coming up tomorrow night, the 7-1 surprising San Diego Chargers. But before, it all starts with NFL Game Day. Preview, Sunday showdown in the National Football League. And of course, NFL primetime with highlights of all the afternoon games. And then we get to the Chargers and the Raiders. Mike Patrick, Roy Firestone, and guest analyst John Matusak. The Twos. Now, he wasn't on low lead when he played. How's he going to be in the booth?
The Twos is a repeat performer. He was good the first time.
Back again for an encore. The NFL comes to ESPN. Penalty against the Pitt Panthers. Moves the ball up now to the 26-yard line. A personal foul call against the Pitt Panthers. Otherwise, it was second and 11. So that's a very costly call. Alexander and Coates are the wide receivers. Coates out of Niles, Ohio, 49. And Alexander in the slot. Kuzi and Wisniewski. Osatsky on the stop again. He hammered Johnny Green out of Youngstown. Osatsky's only 212. That's got to be dripping wet.
And it's got to be less than that at this point. Spindler, 93, still a little bit high, getting driven back. Osatsky, you can see the middle linebacker actually steps up, number 55, inside his own tackle to make the tackle. That's good play by Osatsky, but Spindler again, as I say, he should not be that high. He creates some problems. And they are determined to run on this, what is about a nine-man line for Pittsburgh. Penn State trying to run on.
Kisner just gets rid of it. Caught at the 40-yard line by Michael Timpson. And that will be a Penn State first down, a 13-yard pickup. And the senior out of Pompano Beach, Florida, number 7, Quentin Jones, beaten on the play.
Well, Timpson is a guy who's a track guy. He missed last spring because he was with the track team. He was injured in the preseason. His routes haven't been that good. But when you can make a catch like that, you don't have to run great routes. That's been the problem with the Penn State offense. It's not so much Kisner as the receivers are young, inexperienced, and they have yet to learn to run precise routes. Didn't hurt in that case, though.
Long count by Kisner. Safety valve unloads, got his man, bounces off a couple of Panthers, Michael Alexander, and hammered down at the 46. Spindler, the freshman out of West Scranton, Pennsylvania, and Billy Owens on the stop.
Again, you saw the Pitt people blitzing, coming up to the line, just daring Penn State to throw the ball. Penn State does not want to throw the ball. They'd rather run the ball with Blair Thomas, but Pitt is just shutting it down, going man-to-man on the corners and forcing Kisner to throw those quick patterns.
Maybe, Kevin, one of the reasons they don't want to throw the ball, at the coaches' meeting last night, the coaches told us their passing game about 50% of what they thought it would be at this point in the year. Meanwhile, the running game is at 90%. Timpson coming near side. Blair Thomas going nowhere. Knife down at the 45. And Spindler again on the stop.
When you have the great players in the secondary, it allows you, when you go to man coverage, it allows you to do so much more against the run. And that's what Pitt's doing. They're going to make Penn State beat them at the corners with the pass. And they're going to put the rest of the guys in to stop the run. And it's worked very well so far. Penn State not able to move it all on the ground.
Situation now. Timpson comes wide left, Alexander wide right. Panthers show the blitz and come. Kisner throws it into the tuba section. On his back at the 30-yard line, Osatsky came unimpeded right up the middle. Watch 55. Does he look like he's 212 to you?
Well, there's nobody to block him, Jim. And here's a perfect example. The corner's doing a great job. See, that's not a, it's not an immediate blitz. It's a read blitz. He sees what's happening, sees a hole open up, and he goes. Now, he has that ability, if he wants to shoot the gap if he sees one. And there's the result. Kisner had to throw it away. The secondary right there in that box, man for man on the receivers.
Busy night so far for Chris, and back is Terrell Austin. This is a beautiful spiraling kick. Austin backs up to the 5. never made it to the 15-yard line. Probably should have let it go into the end zone. A 50-yard kick, a 9-yard return. Time has expired. Penn State trailing Pittsburgh 3-0.
Painting is hard work, so you want a paint that works hard for you. A paint that covers in one coat. A paint that's washable. A paint that lasts a long time. A quality paint that's backed by research and careful manufacturing. That's why you should demand Dutch Boy.
Dutch Boy never lets up. He always looks good. He works hard for your money.
Your face takes enough abuse, so you need the Gillette Good News Plus Disposable. Its Lubra Smooth Strip is designed to reduce irritation, so shaving feels so good. Good News Plus.
Entrepreneur. One who assumes the risks of business. Rockwell International managers have the entrepreneurial freedom to move through the maze of business challenges. With advanced technologies and innovative quality products, Rockwell International entrepreneurs get results.
Reach out and touch somebody's hand. Make this world a better place if you can.
Now, every time you use MasterCard, we'll donate money to 6 worthy causes. Look for the balance and help choose where the money goes.
Reach out and touch somebody's hand.
Choose to make a difference. Choose MasterCard.
Look up in the sky. It's a bird. It's a plane. No, it's Beer Nuts. Yes, Beer Nuts, ever ready to rescue your family and friends from snack time boredom. Beer Nuts Peanuts, they're a nut above the rest.
Some people take chances on car maintenance, but I don't. For more than 40 years, I've been sticking with the same brand of auto parts and never been stuck. AC Delco. For my money, you just can't beat them, no matter what kind of car or truck you drive.
Precision AC Delco parts. They don't just fit, they match.
Keep your car running the way it was made to run. For the AC Delco retailer nearest you, just give me a call at 1-800-AC-DELCO.
I'm Jim Kelly along with Kevin Kiley, and welcome back to Pittsburgh, where the Panthers lead the Nittany Lions 3-0. Panthers start deep in their own territory, though, at their own 14. Osborne and Williams wide left and right. Dickerson hot hand in the first quarter, airborne to start the second. Right on the money at the 20-yard line. He's got the Reggie Williams, and they say incomplete. Storyline, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Jeff Van Horn, the only scoring, a 44-yard field goal. Dickerson, the freshman, 5 of 9, 31 yards. Penn State only 8 yards rushing. And Zeke Gadsden with 7 tackles. And how about the containment on Blair Thomas? Hey, that's what the defensive coordinator John Fox told us at practice on Thursday the Panthers had to do.
It's an 8 and 9 man line on Blair Thomas. Unless they complete some passes, he will not run the ball tonight.
Seaman and Kirk. Panthers go with a double tight end. Spread out for Dickerson. Out of bounds at the 12. Trey Bauer, the leading tackler. Inside linebacker, the senior, 6'1", 215, with great speed.
Number 77 on the offensive line for Pittsburgh has had a bad ankle all year. We'll show you later, they've got a device on his ankle. Coming out and making a block, said it saved his life. Mark Stepnowski, he's an All-American candidate, but he's really been hampered by a bad ankle. And they've got a device that they made in West Germany. We'll show you, it's allowed him to play, and he's played well.
Reggie Williams comes to the near side. Osborne and Stewart at the top of your screen. Dickerson needs 10. The draw to Hayward. Ironhead hammers to the 17, and that's all in the grasp of Pete Kuykendall and Pete Dukopoulos, the two veteran seniors for Joe Paterno.
Defense and the kicking game. Penn State, the defense doing their job. And now the question whether their offense is faltering or not, and it is in the first quarter, or it had in the first quarter, whether their kicking game can pick up the slack and get them some field position.
Rasp about 4 yards under his average. His longest punt, 60 yards on the season. But Timpson or Coates? It's Coates at the 43. Dangerous grab. Barrels up to midfield for a return of 7 yards after a punt of 39. So Penn State trails 3-0. They start from midfield.
Wait till you see the changes we're making at Howard Johnson.
This is Howard Johnson?
This is Howard Johnson?
This is Howard Johnson?
This is Howard Johnson.
Bud Thunder. It's revved up and coming at you.
Fred, our little company's moving up.
Well, Max, on our way, let's stop at Computerland. We need another computer.
Computerland was easy on the old budget.
Even taught you to use it, Max.
ESPN's presentation of CFA football is being brought to you by Daly's. Look for your favorite Daly's product in your nearest grocery store. There's a Daly's treat for everyone. And by the heartbeat of America, today's Chevrolet. Sean Borowski checks in now. He's the sophomore out of Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, number 34. He's the fullback. The tailback, number 32, Blair Thomas, and the quarterback, Matt Gisner. Motion across by Timpson. Blair Thomas dances out of one tackle, picks up six all on his own. Zeke Gadsden bumped him out of bounds, the senior from Frogmore, South Carolina. We talked about him at the top of the telecast. They tried him as a wishbone fullback at spring practice. Really, Kevin, you go back to the very first game we did, Pitt at BYU. His season was made right there. He started gaining confidence. He started believing in himself.
Well, that's 90% of it in any sport, I believe. That 81 solo tackles leads everyone else by almost double on this team.
Second and short. Thomas explodes around that left side, blocking by Mark Sickler, the senior out of Moscow, Pennsylvania, and Roger Duffy, the sophomore center out of Canton, Ohio. First down for Joe Paterno's Nittany Lions. Spindler on the stop.
State beginning to establish the running game. Now two runs for a first down. I believe that's the first time they've done it all night here. And we're well into the second quarter.
Timpson comes wide to the right. Line of scrimmage, the 36. Thomas. Boy, does he look like Kurt Warner? Does he look like DJ Dozier? Ballet-like moves.
Well, it's the type of guy, Jimmy's the type of guy that keeps his balance and keeps his shoulders square. Any eye back has to do that. The reason for that is because they want to cut back. See how he plants that foot, keeps the shoulders pretty much square. He's always turning them back square. He's an excellent player and a good runner, but he's got to get the blocking. And if they have a nine-man lineup there, it's going to be difficult.
Thomas, 9 carries, 26 yards. Second and 7, Pumphrey and Marasco, the double tight ends. In now for Penn State. Timpson, like that to the left. Kisner pulls it down. It's batted down at the 31-yard line. Tried a little safety valve pass, took a little bit too much off, and Jerry Wall batted it down.
What a job by Jerry Wall. Now, Jerry Wall was stringing his thing out all the way, had his hands on the offensive blocker, and took his right hand off of the blocker, stuck it up in time to knock the ball down. That's great awareness and coaching. Guy knowing exactly where he is on the field and able to see the quarterback while he's working on the block.
They call Wall Steady Eddie. Compares him to the Steelers ex-linebacker Jack Lambert.
Quietly excellent.
Coates and Timpson for the wideouts. Coates to the near side. Timpson to the far side. Green and Thomas in the backfield. Penalty flags are down. Might have been too much time.
Well, it's either that or it was encroachment on the Pittsburgh defense. They brought everybody. They had a nine-man lineup there again. Kisner didn't know what he was looking at. He might have spooked a lineman. Or it might have been encroachment.
By 26, the senior Zeke Gadsden again.
And this is what Gadsden does so well. He gets his hands immediately on the blocker, keeps him off of him, and he's able to play off, keep contain on Kisner. He knows he's coming. Little love tap and makes him throw the ball away. Good pressure defense by Pittsburgh. Last year they felt they may have been a little passive on defense, and they need to be more aggressive this year, and they certainly have been.
Billy Osborne, one of the sure-handed Pitt Panthers, a wide receiver. I think this might be a fake punt. They'll try to set a field position. Klaus hangs it high. Osborne lets it go, and it's fair caught at the four. Special team, Brennan Gertner, a 32-yard punt. Panthers ball leading 3-0 when we come right back.
What's all the excitement at your Chevy dealers? It's Chevy National Pickup Month. Come see new option packages for 1988 that can save you up to $1,900 on Chevy S10 pickups. And take the test drive of the decade in the advanced new full-size Chevy. The first all-new full-size pickup introduced in this decade. See your Chevy dealer now during Chevy National Pickup Month. Everybody else is.
Cocktail mixes at your favorite store.
Tuesday, there's hard-hitting action when two of the NHL's toughest defensive teams meet face-to-face. The Detroit Red Wings battle the Washington Capitals. Live Tuesday night on ESPN.
In attendance here at Pitt, in the President's Box, former athletic director at Virginia and Cornell, Mr. Dick Schultz, who's now the executive director of the NCAA, sitting with Dr. Wesley W. Posvar, who is in his 21st year, president at Pitt University. The university celebrated their bicentennial this year, 200 years of academic excellence. They welcomed film star Gene Kelly, who was a 33 graduate of Pitt, and they honored a $225 million capital improvement program here on campus. Panthers lead 3-0 from his end zone. The freshman, Dickerson. Penalty flag is down. Dickerson dances to the 5, going east-west, and now goes up to the 7-yard line. Flag was thrown in the end zone. Chismar on the stop of Darnell Dickerson. Holding against Pittsburgh.
Pittsburgh, you saw Pittsburgh's team about 3 or 4 weeks ago before Dickerson, they would never attempt that. And he gives them that option. They can do so many more things with him. He's so mobile, they're not really worried about him being trapped in the end zone, I guess, especially if they're going to hold. But he can throw the sideline route up the field. He's got that great gun, and he can run. So they will do different things. That's more Mike Gottfried's style, throwing from the end zone, throwing all over the field.
Mike, one of the great offensive minds, but he's doing it this year with defense. Experimented on offense, tried the wishbone earlier. There is Terrell Austin, separated shoulder. He's obviously out for the night. Henry Tootin. 81, checks into the lineup at wide receiver. And Hosea Hurd, 85, also checks in. First and 12 after that holding call. Hurd and Osborne slotted wide right, two at the bottom of your screen. And things getting a little sloppy. A little timing problem now for the Panthers.
Dead ball, illegal procedure on the offer. Half the distance of the goal line, first down.
Kevin, if Pittsburgh keeps going this way, they'll be at our hotel. It all starts at 11:30 Eastern time. College football game day. Tim Brando, Beano Cook, Kerry Ross. And then next Saturday, oh, a good one. The Clemson Tigers, ranked number 9. The Gamecocks of South Carolina, ranked number 14. That's where Kevin and I will be. And that stadium will rock. There'll be some noise there. Penn State shifting defensively to almost a prevent. Hayward hammers up the middle. And Ironhead rambles for big yardage up near the 13 in the grasp of Willie Thomas. Now, you're Willie Thomas, Kevin. You're 5'9", 175 pounds, and here comes this locomotive at you.
Well, you're real nervous, Jim, when that happens. It shouldn't really happen on the goal line. Penn State got him back where they want him. Here's Giftopoulos, the linebacker, maybe overrun a little thing. Gets pinned off on the outside by Prentice Wright. And number 34, loose in the secondary, exactly where you don't want him.
You don't want him coming at you.
No.
Pittsburgh needs one. Tackled near the 18, Pete Giftopoulos, the first to get there, senior out of Hamilton, Ontario. He was born in Canada, and a late penalty flag down.
Dead ball, personal foul on the defense.
Mistakes, exactly what Joe Paterno does not like from his team. Let him out of the shadow of their end zone, and they're out now. Now here's Stepnowski, number 77, playing with that device I talked about, making the trap, and Hayward, big hole there. You got to close quicker. Take a look at this device. In West Germany, it was invented. Now, it goes all up around the foot and the ankle. You can see here's the side. It's got a hinge on it. It allows your foot to move up and down, but not side to side. And that was the problem with Stepnowski. A great player, but you can't play unless your ankle is stable. It's stable now.
And to wear that thing, he has to use four rolls of tape. Dickerson. Throws it incomplete and a late flag.
Well, I think that flag should be intentionally grounding and not roughing. There was no one he could possibly have been throwing that ball to. Craig Hayward made a big mistake. He had a chance at Karpinski at the corner, and he kept going. He didn't run a pass pattern. He didn't actually do anything. And Karpinski went right by him, made the play.
Karpinski, 84, putting pressure on Dickerson. Now, let's see if Darnell has anybody.
No, there was nobody out there. Nobody. Well, Bauer.
Ray Bauer got it.
That's loss of down, too. That's a big penalty. Good play. Another big play by Karpinski. You have to seal the corner. Now, if Hayward's going to go out and run a pattern, it's one thing, but he's got to check for that backer and seal the corner for Dickerson.
Osborne brings in the play. What you're seeing is a great defensive game on both sides of the ball.
This could be expected. I would have expected this. These are excellent defensive teams.
Williams wide left. Stewart and Osborne wide at the top of your screen. Penn State showing blitz. Dickerson gives the ball off to Ironhead. Hammers up across the 20 to the 21. Karpinski's got him there.
Karpinski hurt earlier in the year. We saw him against Boston College. He had such a big game. Again, recognition. He starts outside. He reads it back inside. Gets in on the play. Senior. They've got four senior linebackers in there, and that will help you defensively. And they're all good ones.
Karpinski had a great Fiesta Bowl last year, putting all kinds of pressure on Vinny Testaverde. Out of Warren De La Salle High School, he played linebacker and tight end. A little hitch delay to Prentice Wright. And protecting that 3-0 lead after penalties and mistakes, the Panthers will give up the football. Looks like Eric Dickerson with those goggles, doesn't he?
That's interesting that Mike Gottfried has opened up the offense, but the results so far have been basically the same. Playing against one of the better defenses in the nation, he's not been able to get a touchdown.
Johnny Rasp will punt. Missed most of the spring practice with a bad ankle. Also plays basketball for the Panthers. Timpson and Coates are back deep. Coates at the 40. So again, the Penn State Nittany Lions with good field position, 60 yards away from six, and they trail by three.
To Michelob.
Can't breathe. Can't sleep.
Before and Afrin. Relief so you can sleep. What Afrin does in 5 minutes takes Sudafed over an hour. It's the number one recommended nasal spray.
Xerex. The antifreeze that beats winter. Available now.
Down in Baton Rouge, LSU trying to stay in the Sugar Bowl chase, but Mississippi State roaring back. Hank Phillips with a touchdown run, and it's now 14-7 Tigers. That game now in the first quarter. And by the way, Jim Kelly and Kevin Kiley, Miami supposedly on its way to the Orange Bowl, tied 10-10 at halftime against Virginia Tech.
And Timmy, they were like a 37-point favorite in that game. So the Hurricanes having some problems. You can explain the bowl picture, Tim, at halftime. First and 10 from the 40. Penn State trails. They'll be going to a bowl. Blair Thomas, a little stutter step for one. Second down and 9. Gadsden on the tackle. Joe Paterno on the sideline. We talked about it at the very top of the telecast, Kevin. He builds with the defense. He takes the best athletes available, starts from there, then works on the kicking game, and the leftovers go to offense, sort of.
That's not, well, you would think that's kind of extreme if you had never heard that before, but that's, a lot of coaches feel that way. I played for some coaches that felt that way. They believe that if you can keep the other team from scoring, the worst you can do is a tie. And that doesn't mean to say if they have a great quarterback like Kisner you see there or a tailback like Blair Thomas, they're going to move them to defense. It's worked for Joe Paterno over the years, but you better know your defense. You better know how to coach defense, and you better be able to stop teams, or else you're going to be in trouble. And of course, Paterno has been able to do it. He won't take chances on offense either, as you look as a pit player down on the field.
Carnell Smith, the sophomore out of Toledo, most improved defensive player for Pittsburgh back in the spring, is down, so they are tending to him, and the clock is stopped with 9:11 left to go in the first half. Pittsburgh leading 3-0. Well, a lot of folks call it the game of the decade. You can't argue. Boy, if you saw the highlights and the tapes, Oklahoma against Nebraska. And we'll have it for you again here on ESPN. You'll see the Heisman Trophy winner, Johnny Rogers, Oklahoma's great Greg Pruitt, Friday night at midnight, and then again Saturday morning at 10 o'clock. The game of the decade. You remember that game?
I certainly do. I was 3 years old when that game was played. I can remember the colors going by on the screen.
Boy. All those antihistamines have gone to your head.
They say this guy's got ice water in his veins. He may get a chance to prove it by the end of this game with a 3-0 lead against Penn State and bowl hopes riding on it.
Matt Kisner looking at second down and 8:58 left to go before halftime. Penn State just one play off. Panthers showing a blitz, and here they come. Reads it, safety bounce it out to Timpson. Timpson explodes for a first down at the 45-yard line of Pitt. Gary Richard on the stop, the senior out of Denver, Colorado.
Now this is an audible. That's why it took so long for this thing to get going. Watch the pick. Bottom of your screen, you're going to see the inside receiver come out off the pick. You see the pick? And then the delivery by Kisner. Now, that's actually, they didn't hit the player, but when they come that close, it's just like basketball. Very tough to cover them. An audible by Kisner, and it worked very well for Penn State.
Slot to the left. Straight drop. Man open over the middle. The tight end dropped at the 17-yard line. Paul Pomfret had a touchdown. The senior out of Clifton, New Jersey, was wide open.
And Pittsburgh's been daring them to throw this thing the whole game. They've got 8 and 9 man line. They're playing man-to-man on the corners. And that leaves him either on a safety, number 88, left corner of your screen, on a safety or a linebacker. See the corner playing a wide out? You got a linebacker. No chance of covering Pomfret. That ball right on the nose. And he drops it. what the heck? Right on the money.
Right on the money. Right on the money. That's not a cliche. We'll give you a cliche. Inside to the 39, third and five coming up. Troy Washington, the junior out of Duquesne, Pennsylvania, on the stop. 6'2", 190 pounds.
It'll be a long night for Thomas. Now, Pitt, the reason that play almost worked, the two plays before to the tight ends, because Pittsburgh has just got 8, 9 guys up there, and they're just daring him to throw the ball. And Penn State is going to have to connect on a few. Pomfret's going to have to catch it.
Thomas looked a little tired right there. They trail by three. Panthers make the blitz. Kisner incomplete at the 10. Misthrown. Looking for Timpson. On the fly pattern. So the punt team comes out for the Penn State Nittany Lions again. Throwing into double coverage. Quentin Jones and Troy Washington were back there stride for stride.
Oh, they're showing him an 8-man line here. You can see up there. And then you've got Quentin Jones man-to-man. But the safety's coming over. That ball overthrown. They're putting a lot of pressure on Kisner to be accurate. He hasn't been accurate. All right, well, on that play, he certainly hit Pomfret.
Klaus has been accurate, but this time, well, he gets a good bounce, like a knuckleball. It goes backwards. Looked like Joe Negro with sandpaper. A 35-yard punt down inside the five at the three. Pitch ball when we come back.
Includes a run to a true.
Hi, I'm Earl Christie for Deals on Wheels, where they're always playing the Super Bowl of used car deals. Deals on Wheels, all pro staff are ready to pull you off the sideline and put you into a dependable used car. All their cars come with limited warranty and guaranteed to pass the Delaware State inspection. Their on-site credit company gets the ball moving. Even if you have little or no credit, don't call timeout. At Deals on Wheels, your job is your credit. So run on down to Deals on Wheels and catch yourself a great used car.
Just air compressor companies in the world also services Delmarva. Ingersoll Rand through Wharton and Barnard, providing the proper equipment for the right job, no matter how large or small. Ensuring quick and thorough service before, during, and after the sale. Ingersoll Rand, 5 to 500 horsepower available. Next time you're in the market, remember, nobody compresses air like Ingersoll Rand. Solid enough to never let you down. With Wharton and Barnard, we build confidence.
There's our time left before halftime. 7:42, a 44-yard field goal by Jeff Van Horn, and that has been all the scoring. Osborne comes wide to the left side. Williams wide to the right. Lavinia's the fullback. The tailback is Ironhead. Tries it around the right side. Stepnoski and Miller on the blocking. And Trey Bauer, number 35, the senior out of Paramus, New Jersey, on the hit. He entered 87 with twice as many tackles as the other Nittany Lions.
Very tough to block the inside backers for Penn State, too. They'll stack quite often behind the linemen. And by the time you get to them, they're gone. That's what happened with Bauer there. He read it. He was able to come in and make the tackle.
Well, he said it's a great defensive game. Hayward, 7 carries for 23 yards. Thomas, 11 carries for 33. From the end zone, Dickerson in be careful range, dives to the 5. Schoenwolf has him there.
What you see here is Mike Godfrey's willingness to do things to open up the offense, but a good job by Penn State on coverage. Now, Dickerson, as quick as he is on the outside, he drops back, recognizes immediately that there's nothing there, and gets himself out of the end zone. Good heady play for a freshman.
Joan Wolf on the stop, moved back to defensive tackle after spending the spring trying out an offensive guard. Dickerson needs 11 from the end zone again. Sideline, got his man at the 15. Loose football. Penn State's got it. Reggie Williams fumbled the football, and the Nittany Lions had their deepest penetration.
Kicking game put him in good position. The defense takes the ball away. It's amazing how they do this. Dickerson, good read. Hits Reggie right in the chest. Now he's got the first down. There's the hand right on the ball. And the rest of the Nittany Lion defense give Topolis, who always seems to be around the ball, I don't know if he recovered it, but he was right there. Defense and the kicking game. He told us last night he's done nothing offensively. But here they are in position again.
Willie Thomas, the man that forced the fumble, the freshman, they've been picking on him. He atones. First and 10, Penn State from the 15 and 5. Blair Thomas explodes for 6. Second and 4 coming up. Bert Grossman on the stop. The junior out of Ballack-Kinwood, Pennsylvania, helped out by Jerry Wall.
It's a natural lift for an offense when their defense turns the ball over to them, and a natural down for a defense that's sitting on a sideline not expecting to go in. Great teams overcome that. They've got to get on the field and get themselves ready to protect their goal line. Pitt needs to do that right now.
Thomas now 12 carries, 39 yards. Clayton in. That tackle. Thomas just hammered straight ahead. Close to first down yardage. If he got inside the 5, it's first and goal.
Nothing
it's
fancy.
It's first and goal.
Nothing fancy, a legitimate 9-man line there. Osatsky, the small middle linebacker, 55 in the blue jersey. They're going to come out and get him. He's been able to get away. But see, now he's got to come straight at the ball carrier because he's protecting his goal line. His shiftiness doesn't help him. You see what happens to him? He had to go right at Blair Thomas. And the blockers were able to get to him, and they buried him. That's the difference in goal line defense. Nothing fancy here.
Borowski, Gash, and Thomas, double tight end. Humphrey and Borosco. Motion by Gash, and now by Blair Thomas. Stop at the 4. Quentin Jones, the senior out of Pompano Beach, Florida.
Nice job. Small middle linebackers, they like to run. Now, see, he knows it's wide. They don't go straight at him, and he's able to get outside and now come up and make the great hit and drop him for little or no gain. He's a running guy. They have to protect Osofsky. He's not a guy who can take on blockers and play straight-ahead defense. You saw two great examples of it there in the last two plays. Covered. The defensive linemen are down there covering all the offensive linemen. Here's Osofsky. See, there's nobody on him. Somebody trying to pull Osofsky just comes right up and meets the ball carrier head on. He's protected. He's stacking. He's behind that defense. There's nobody can get to him, and he makes the play. It makes him so valuable. He recognizes things so well. Power won't do it on this play. They're going to have to try something wide or tricky.
Looking for Borowski, one of only 5 freshmen to work his way onto the depth chart last year.
Well, that was wide and tricky. Well, there was no way they were going to go up the middle on Pitt, even though they had a full house backfield, so they give it to Blair Thomas. Pass run option, and the thing is no good from the start. Over the end line. Great defensive stand by the Pitt Panthers.
And pressure by Gary Richard, the senior out of Denver, on Blair Thomas to force that throw out of the end zone. Out of the hold of Lance Lonergan. It is blocked. Taurasi had that field goal try blocked from the 14.
Number 6. Now, I don't believe they ever got the ball down. Lonergan mishandled this snap, ball down. That thing was late and offline to begin with. Great play by Pitt defensively.
Blocking on the right, his biggest carry of the night, a first down. Range on the stop. As 260 pounds, rambled for 14 big ones.
Well, just as we said earlier, when you get a turnover, a big defensive play, emotions play a big part. Now, this guy, you said 260, Jim, they say 275. And iron head, iron thighs is in the back. He's in the backfield and he's pumping people. Last year he had a big first half and he tired in the second half. But they haven't used iron head so much here in the first half. I think it's 8 carries so far. So they're saving him for the second half. 8 carries, 37 yards.
Darnell, sideline. The receiver Osborne turned it up. And Darnell read it wrong on a comeback route. Incomplete, brings up second down and 10.
Dickerson looking upset, and he should be. His receiver either went the wrong way or he threw the wrong pattern. But in the spring game, Mike Godfrey told us that he knew he had something special when he put Dickerson in the spring game. He ran 6 plays and made 6 mistakes. Either threw to the wrong receiver, went the wrong way, called the wrong play, and they were in the end zone in 6 plays anyway. He knew he had an athlete, and he's got him out here tonight.
They compare Darnell's arm to that of Dan Marino. Quick snap. Quick feet. Unloads it high, incomplete at the 20, and it's just as well. Stewart would have lost 3 yards. Karpinski on the coverage.
That was an interesting play. Stewart did the right thing coming back to help his quarterback, but you can only come back so far. He came back the other side of the line of scrimmage. And had they, as you said, Jim, had they completed that thing, it would have been for a 3-yard loss.
Darnell looks just a little confused.
Well, I think that the crowd is screaming. This has been kind of a crazy game. It's Penn State, and I think he's getting a little rattled out there. He's kind of jumping around on both feet.
Panthers have missed on their last 6 tries on third down. Incomplete. Quintus McDonald, I think, got a hand on the football. And Darnell, you can see the frustration etched on his face. Just a freshman. He has only 9 quarters of varsity action at Pitt.
I'd be alarmed if I saw that look if I was Mike Godfrey. He's starting to think about it. Now this ball is hit. The arm is hit. Coming around the side. As I said, Dickerson, if he came to the bench with that look on his face, I'd have to talk to him and consider taking him out. He's starting to get down on himself.
Will get a roughing the kicker. It bounces dead at the 30, but a roughing the kicker call as Rask was on his backside.
I do not know how Rask gets this ball off. Now they've got this thing blocked, and if they touch it at all, that's a great job by Rask. If they touch it at all, it's not roughing the kicker. Sure. It looked like they were all over that thing, Jim, and he just managed to get it under the arm.
Schoenwolf, the junior out of Philadelphia, 6'4", 259, got Rask. So it's a first down for Pittsburgh. Joe Paterno does not like the call. Said, wait a minute, we got part of the ball.
They did not get part of the ball. The first replay showed that it got off cleanly.
But Joe's going to argue he got part of it.
And who can blame him? I go back to the Boston College game when they had the roughing the kicker penalty on Boston College. Penn State kicked the field goal, went on to win the game. Big penalty. Roughing the kicker, always a big penalty.
Who's going to argue with a man who's won 2 national championships? Kind of like arguing with Don Shula. From the 37, a first down for Pitt. Wright and Hayward in the backfield. Ironhead. He just pushed his own blocker out of the way. While we reset the down and distance, let's check in with Tim Brando. What's going on with Mississippi State and LSU? Timmy?
All right, right now, the LSU Tigers are in a bit of trouble down in the Bayou. Freshman quarterback Eric Underwood to the sophomore tight end Jesse Anderson, and Mississippi State has tied it. Remember, should LSU lose, then Alabama would play Auburn on November 27th for the right to go to the Sugar Bowl.
Timmy, I'll make you a little bet. If LSU doesn't go to the Sugar Bowl, they'll go to Orlando, Florida, and they'll meet Penn State.
Obviously, we're having some technical difficulties with our transmission coming out of Pitt Stadium. As we mentioned, the score right now, the Pitt Panthers clinging precariously against Penn State, and we'll be obviously working on those problems that are going on currently, and we'll be back to update the halftime situation. And what was that bet you were about to make with me, Jim?
Well, Timmy, I just said that we'll talk about it after this commercial message. Let's make some money.
Smile. The easy does a 35 for pictures that come alive. 35 millimeter?
It's easy.
Kodak beyond 35.
Ta-da!
You just drop the film in. It almost loads itself. Then aim and shoot.
Have you ever seen a sharper baby picture?
I have.
Whichever one you want to choose, we've got the 35 for you. Kodak beyond 35.
It's a great shot.
Nothing to it.
GMAC makes financing or leasing the new GM car or truck of your dreams easy. Just see your General Motors dealer. We'll help your dream come true.
The dreams of America, GMAC. We're making your dreams come true. The dreams of America, GMAC.
Official sponsor of America's Dreams.
Former college football player Steve Garbin.
My father was a coal miner, and attending college was not a subject for discussion as I was growing up. Without a football scholarship, I would not have attended college. This was important to me because competing in sports leaves you with values that you use throughout your life, like the need to work hard, discipline, self-confidence, and teamwork.
The preceding brought to you by the College Football Association.
From the Penn State sideline, the Nittany Lions got down inside the five. They had it first and goal from the four. Then a blocked field goal try for the equalizer. And after a roughing the kicker call, Pittsburgh gets the ball back from their own 42. Second and five. Dickerson pulls it down, can run. First down inside Penn State territory, out of bounds at the 48-yard line. Chased out by Keith Karpinski. Ricketts with a big block, the junior out of Murraysville, Pennsylvania.
Now, Ricketts is a guy who's really had to change his blocking style. They all have, because Janella wasn't all that mobile. Now, here he comes out on Karpinski. Number 71, Ricketts, doing a good job on Karpinski, as you see, and number 15, Dickerson, getting up inside. Now, last week, Dickerson was running back and forth across the field, and the guys were getting exhausted. This guy in particular trying to block for him.
Over the middle is wide open. Oh, what a collision at the 28. Reggie Williams and Range. And Reggie bounces up like a pinball. You talk about inner toughness, you know that hurt. You just don't want to let Penn State know how much it hurt.
And watch the bottom of your screen. You can see this coming all the way. They let him go inside. They play him outside in. The ball's right there, and so is Range. Now, I'll tell you what, Range could have done a lot more damage than that. It was almost as if he couldn't get out of the way. He was there. He'd have lowered his shoulder, it would have been worse. Luckily for Williams, and you're right, Williams jumped right up, and that's what a receiver has to do. Whether he hurts or not, take it to the sideline. Don't let him know you got it, and he hurt you.
Dickerson, one out of six this quarter for just 10 yards. Needs 10 here on second down. Open over the middle, misfires too high. Looking for Henry Tootin. Tootin is a six-footer. Could have been Wilt Chamberlain, and that one would have been too high.
You know, they may be asking Dickerson to do more now than he's capable of doing. Look at his face. I don't think he really understands what he's looking at back there. That was not a good pass. A floater over the middle into a deep zone. If that ball hadn't been way overthrown, it would have certainly been intercepted. Got to keep him within his abilities if they're going to be successful.
6 out of 15, Dickerson is. 59 yards so far on the night. 3rd and 10. State drives everybody back. Deflected and incomplete, almost intercepted by Range at the 34-yard line. Now, Dickerson was actually going for Reggie Williams deep on a curl in, and one of the Panthers got into the pattern and batted the ball up, thinking it's for him.
Well, this is a rifle, Jim. A rifle, and a high rifle, which is not good. See, that's another thing. If you're going to throw the ball hard as a quarterback, you've got to throw it within the body of the receiver so he can catch it or knock it down.
Off the side of his kick. off the side of his foot, Johnny Rasp, out of bounds at the 24-yard line. 2.5 left to go, a 24-yard kick. Number 26, Zeke Gadsden, eligible for the Butkus Award, along with Paul McGowan, Romanowski, Jones, Norton, Waiters, and Spielman. Who do you think is his toughest competition?
Well, I would think Kenny Norton and Spielman would be the toughest because of the publicity factor. Gadsden was a write-in this year. He's the first player since they began the Butkus Awards a couple of years ago ever to be written in. He was not initially at the start of the season a candidate, but he has played so well, and as you see tonight, what a big factor he is that he is now. He's not only a candidate, a leading contender.
First and 10, Penn State. 2.5 to go before halftime. 76 yards away from a touchdown. Blair Thomas, inside blocking by Kuzi, Duffy, Wisniewski up front, and Jerry Wall, and yet another stop.
But I honestly believe, and I'd be willing to say, if Penn State does not get touchdown, get points from their defense, they will not win this game. They have not taken advantage of Pittsburgh's ability to stop the run, the nine-man line, the eight-man line, and the only thing they can do against it is throw the ball, and their passing game has not been that strong. They will not win this game if they don't get something out of their defense in terms of points.
Incomplete at the 35-yard line, looking for Alexander. Quentin Jones, the senior out of Pompano Beach, Florida, back there in the coverage. You can't play the corner any better than that.
Yeah, their receivers do not match up well. There is this Quentin Jones. Their receivers are not beating the corners man-to-man. And because of that, Pittsburgh is just not going to get out of their nine-man line.
Kisner now is also, like Darnell Dickerson, 1 out of 6 passing. Just 13 yards this quarter. A great defensive effort by Pitt and by Penn State. Motion by Michael Timpson. Delay, Blair Thomas. Up to the 34-yard line. That's close to first down yardage. Zeke Gadsden, the write-in candidate for the Butkus Award, on the stop. Gadsden, 107 tackles, 1 interception. 5 fumbles caused and 2 fumble recovered coming into this game. Hurry up offense now for Penn State. 140 and counting. Kisner on first down. Pump fake. Fires to the sideline. Incomplete. Looking for Timpson.
It's a great job by Richard on the corner again. Throwing a floater out there. Threw it out of bounds. There's just no way that they're able to get free. Play before that was an interesting play with the motion man, where they sent the motion guy the other way and they tried to trap back on a counter with Blair Thomas. There was no secondary people on that side. If he had broken that play, he could have run for a lot of yardage. I think we'll see that again.
Alexander and Timpson slotted out top of your screen. Backs are Borowski and Thomas. Borowski hammers behind Clayton and Wisniewski. Spindler and Osaski on the stop. They say of Jerry Osaski, 212, maybe 200. He doesn't impress you when he walks into a room. But he's a hitter with good instincts. Hurry up offense again. Kisner, 3rd and 8. Looks down the middle. Nobody's there. To the 46, and that should be another Penn State first down. Osaski on yet another stop. 64 seconds left before we go back for scores and highlights with Tim Brando. And we've got a triple header today. On Thursday night, another game. The Wildcats of Villanova and the Holy Cross Crusaders. Thursday night, Gordy Lockbaum makes his national television debut. The Crusaders undefeated. Roll to another big win today. Denny Schreiner and Stan White. All of the action at 8 o'clock Eastern time coming up from Philadelphia.
And I'm going to watch that game because I want to see Gordy Lockbaum. I have never seen the guy play. He's got to be an unbelievable athlete.
Okay. I'll watch it too. Same reason. Because I used to live in Philadelphia.
All right. There'll be a test after the game.
We'll call each other.
Okay.
I'll call you collect.
All right. No. No.
64 seconds left to go. A 44-yard field goal by Jeff Van Horn put that man's team up on top 3-0. Mike Gottfried in his second confrontation against Joe Paterno and Penn State.
things to think about here. Penn State does not like to throw the ball over the middle. You've got a minute to go, so you can play your receiver a little bit outside and force him across the middle. When I say across the middle, I mean short crossing patterns, because they figure that the turnover ratio is too high. What you're looking for here is probably Blair Thomas on some kind of a wide swing play, or these hooks to the outside, something that if it's not complete, they will not turn the ball over. As you get closer down, with 20 or 30 seconds to go, they might try something long down the middle, because if it's turned over, it'd be as good as a punt. So you want to play it inside out.
Alexander wide to the bottom of your screen. Timpson to the top. Kisner on a slant in post. Incomplete at the 45-yard line. Timpson hammered there. First to arrive was Billy Owens and Gary Richard.
This thing thrown behind him, very nearly intercepted. Kisner showing good strength. See that? A high pass behind him. And Osowski again. That ball pops up in the air. It could have been intercepted. Penn State really has an aversion to throwing those things over the middle, because Joe Paterno just simply feels there's too many players in there defensively, and they have too many opportunities to pick it off and go the other way.
And the senior quarterback out of Youngstown, Pennsylvania, has missed his last six passes in a row. Blair Thomas on the draw. Chased down by number 26, Zeke Gadsden.
The thing that Gadsden does so well, and maybe better than anybody else, is he attacks the blocker, but he keeps an arm's distance. He'll keep an arm's distance and be able to get away from the blocker. See how he gets his hands on the blocker right away, and now the great speed from behind, he picks off Blair Thomas. That's just athletic ability, not just a great linebacker. There's just not many people that can do that.
Gadsden right there with 6'4 speed in the 60-yard dash on the Pitt track team. At halftime, scores and highlights with Tim and Vino, and there were some updates. They'll try and clarify some of the bowl picture at least, and interviews with Michigan State head coach George Perlis. His Spartans look like they're headed to Pasadena. And with Todd Santos, you'll see him in action coming up on our triple header coming up right after this Pitt-Penn State clash.
Remember the tight end now. Remember the tight end? He was wide open down the middle. That's a potential play. Blair Thomas.
Joe Paterno has never lost here at Pitt Stadium. 7 wins, no losses, and 1 tie. Thomas rushing, 6 carries, 8 yards in the first, 11 carries, 49 yards in the second. Not a factor. The Pitt defense doing a great job. Timpson line to the bottom of your screen. Alexander at the top. Panthers are showing the blitz. Looks back across the middle, incomplete at the 30, looking for Timpson. Threw it into double coverage. Troy Washington, the junior out of Duquesne, Pennsylvania, who really has assumed the leadership role on this defensive front back there on the coverage.
And he almost had that thing over the middle, and he almost made Joe Paterno's predictions about throwing over the middle come true. Two receivers out, max protection, nobody was open.
45 seconds now left before halftime. Osborne with a good hand. The wide receiver standing back at his own 11. Klaus hangs it high. This is a towering kick. Osborne, fair catches at the 12. 38 seconds left to go. And how will Mike Gottfried play it? Close to the vest? A 3-0 lead. You certainly don't want to risk the interception.
This would be devastating, not just for the game, but to his freshman quarterback. And I think he knows it. Something safe, maybe let him keep the ball and roll out without handing it off. 3-0 over Penn State at home. Good enough.
Mike worked late into the afternoon, had that late lunch. Dry wheat bread with turkey and nothing else.
That's all I could do to keep from asking for something.
The salad. He did have some dressing. Inside is 30 seconds right now. So with that 3-0 lead, Pittsburgh content to sit on it. And it's Mike Gottfried's type of game. He talked at the very top about, well, there are two ways to play this game. Close to the vest, rely on your defense, try to put just enough points on the board, and then play protect or open things up. And I think with the confusion of Dickerson in the second quarter, Pitt went into a shell offensively.
Yeah, I think what we're looking at here is Joe Paterno. At any time with that kicking game, maybe a turnover, they've done it so many times, he could turn this thing around in a hurry. 3 points is not enough against the Nittany Lions.
A 44-yard field goal by Jeff Van Horn. That's been all the scoring. And in the 87th renewal, Pitt leads Penn State 3-0. Let's go back to the studio and rejoin Timmy.
All right, Jim and Kevin, thank you very much. Well, obviously, there are bowl ramifications all across college football, and the same goes for that game right there. We do have a happy Big Ten champion. You'll be hearing from Michigan State head coach George Perlis, plus the rest of the bowl picture on the Met halftime scoreboard. Right now, the Panthers lead by 3 at Pitt Stadium over the Nittany Lions at the half.
Your face takes enough abuse, so you need the Gillette Good News Plus disposable. Its Lubra Smooth Strip is designed to reduce irritation, so shaving feels so good. Good News Plus.
You know, there are a lot of places where you can look for an auto part, but here's where you'll find it. NAPA has parts for imports and other hard-to-find parts. So come to NAPA first. We've got your part.
Avoid the Noid. With the Domino's Pizza Guarantee. We guarantee your pizza will be delivered within 30 minutes or you get $3 off your order. Guaranteed. And we guarantee your pizza will taste great. If you're not satisfied with your pizza, we'll replace it or refund your money. Only our pizza is guaranteed to avoid the Noid. Domino's Pizza delivers. Call now.
I never realized the world was so full of hazards.
That's why there's a company like MetLife. Because sometimes things do get out of control.
Hey!
That's why over 43 million people look to Met to be there when things go wrong. That's why you should get Met.
It pays.
The CFA scoreboard is being brought to you by Metropolitan Life and affiliated companies. Get Met, it pays.
A big, big day in college football. The Met halftime scoreboard is underway. Let's get right to it. Beginning with the Rose Bowl picture in the Big Ten. It would be settled today at East Lansing. Would they keep the Rose Bowl team from the Big Ten in the state of Michigan? Well, here's Bobby McAllister making absolutely certain things go George Perlis's way. Andre Rison, clearly one of the most talented wide receivers in college football. The touchdown there in the second, making it 14-3. Then in the third, McAllister, what an athlete he is. He gets away from a number of would-be tacklers, gets a good block, and is in to the 5-yard line and down to the 1, and that would lead to a touchdown jaunt by Lorenzo White. What a performance for White. 56 carries, one short of an NCAA record, 292 yards, 27-3, the final score. And the Spartans are on their way to the Rose Bowl in Pasadena, ending 22 years of frustration within the Big Ten. And George Perlis, after the game was over, obviously was quite elated, and our Alan Massengale had an opportunity to visit with him.
Thanks, Timmy. It may be November, but everything came up roses here in East Lansing today for Michigan State coach George Perlis. And George, a 5-year plan that you had seemed to pay off today because you devastated Indiana, frankly.
Well, we played well offensively and defensively. We played with a little more emotions than I thought we were going to play with. We played a little better than I thought we were going to play. And we had to play that way because Indiana was ready, and they got on the board early, and I was scared to death. But the players got themselves together and played well the rest of the game.
George, 22 years. You seem to be taking this very low-key, but I know there's a lot of emotion building in you for what you've accomplished in Michigan State in the green going back to Pasadena.
Well, it is. It seems like I'm a little sober because the only thing goes through my mind, there's a lot of things going. You think about your family. Really, I'm very thankful of all the good things, and I think of Biggie and Duffy. We had a memorial mass for Duffy this morning. His wife was here at the game, his children, so I still think of them.
Congratulations once again, Coach, and have a good time. Yeah!
26-3 today, Michigan State. Let's go back to Tim Brando.
All right, Alan, and our congratulations to George Perlis and the Michigan State program. Now, as for the Pac-10, who will play them? Well, UCLA obviously looking good. 47-14 the final, 17 third quarter points. Eric Ball, two touchdowns in the game. Now, USC had to win, obviously, to set up the showdown.
At the 12. 25. And he's got some room. Nice move at the 33 and is down at the 35-yard line. A great return to start the second half, a 22-yard return. Let's check those halftime statistics.
Well, passing yards, as you can see, Penn State did nothing passing. Pittsburgh started out a lot better, ended up with 58 yards. The rushing yards have been completely shut down on the ground. Both teams attribute to the defenses. Actually, statistics really do reflect this game. It's 3-0, and it's not likely to get any crazier out here with the defenses playing as well as they have been.
From the 35, Dickerson bends in, gives to Ironhead, breaks it for his second largest carry of the night. His longest run in the first half for 14 yards. That for seven. He has 9 carries now, 44 yards. And Kevin, he's got a string of 9 straight games with 100 plus yards.
Yeah, very unusual. He only had 8 carries in the first half. They've saved him. And you see the linebackers not getting up into the hole quick enough, and you don't want to give this guy momentum. A good job by the Pitt offensive line.
Driven backwards by 1, 2, 3 white jerseys. Gary Wilkerson, the first to arrive out of Sutherland, Virginia, the junior, 178 pounds. He gave up almost 100 pounds and drove Ironhead backwards.
Ironhead had no momentum. He had jumped a little bit there, and Wilkerson able to get him. Now, Pittsburgh's offense looks like they're going to commit to the run here early in the second half. They've saved Hayward in the first half, so we can look for maybe to keep it on the ground on the first and second down.
Reggie Williams wide to the left. Stewart and Osborne, top of your screen. 3rd and 5. First down and look out. Chismar made the stop where it was 6.
Boy, nice job by Chismar, faced with almost an impossible task. Again, good blocking. They cross him up. 3rd and long. No chance right there for Giftopoulos. And now he just undercut him. See what Chismar did? He just threw that shoulder and back in there. I believe if he had tried to hit the big man there on the side and get him down, he'd have bounced right off.
Great smile for Craig. 11 carries, 57 yards, and a first down at the 44 of Penn State. Back to number 34, and Craig cracks it down to about the 43. Trey Bauer stopped him there. Panthers, I think, Kevin, just happy not to look at their own goalposts. Their last 4 drives started at the 4, the 6, the 8, and the 12. This one from their own 35.
It's that Penn State kicking game. I believe Mike Gottfried went in at halftime and said, 30 minutes, and you've got this one, and he got him pumped up. And I really believe Pittsburgh's defense set the tone of this game. They've completely shut down the Penn State offense.
Reggie Williams wide to the left, out of the screen, top of the screen, Osborne and Stewart. Dickerson unloads, gets it to Reggie, knows he's going to get popped, and he does. And now he drops the ball, and they're saying it's an incompleted pass. Reggie can't believe it. Quintus McDonald made the hit.
He never had it. He never had it. He was juggling this ball all the way down, and there's Dickerson with that look again. Watch him. He never really has this ball. See it? It's good defense right there. That ball sticking up in the air. That would have been an interception had he grabbed it on the way across.
Henry Tootin checks in. Number 81. Looks like Wally Henry, former pro player with the Philadelphia Eagles. 3rd and 10. Tootin is only 6 feet, 175 pounds. Blitz. Dickerson. A sliding catch at the 33, out of bounds. Michael Stewart hung onto the ball, but couldn't get that foot down over on the far sideline.
Again, you see the ability that Dickerson has just ahead of the defense, and a pretty accurate play. Actually didn't have, I think the feet were in when the ball hit his pad. He just did not have control of it.
Rasp standing back at his own 42. Coach 49 right on your screen. And this kick is a high, high spiral. Doesn't turn over. Coach slides for it at the 12. And is upended there. And a late penalty flag. Eric Holdsworth called for the personal foul. Now, did you see Coach put up the hand for the fair catch?
Yes, I did.
Obviously, Holdsworth did not, and Coach is down at the 10.
What happened here is he put it up early and then started to run. The ball died, and he started to run.
The foul on the kicking team. It will be first down.
What you'll see, you'll see him put his hand up and then have to chase the ball. Now, there's your fair catch signal, but the ball was drifting in the wind, and as he chased it, he came so far from the point where the fair catch signal was made that that was the result. That's a tough penalty. Eric Holdsworth.
So the ball moves all the way up to the 27-yard line, and there is Coach down at the 10. 12:26 left to go in the third quarter. Three nothing, Pittsburgh on top. And of course, every Saturday afternoon, well, we've got football action, but before that at 11:30, it's game day with Tim Brando, Beano Cook, and Kerry Ross. And next Saturday night, Kevin and I, oh, will that be a noisy stadium. South Carolina, the Gamecocks, ranked 14th against the number 9 ranked Clemson Tigers, and then the Air Force Falcons and the Rainbows in Hawaii. You felt like that a few times. Some of them after a football game.
I played on a lot of kickoff teams and punt teams, and that's a really a tough thing to have to come down like Holdsworth did and cover a punt, especially when he moves so far. There's a lot of indecision on the defensive or the punt covering guy whether or not he can hit him.
Alexander wide left, Timpson to the near side. Blair Thomas, 17 carries, 54 yards in the first half. He's the tailback, he's got the ball. All of that on his own. There was no hole. He created one up to the 34. Osaski submarined him there.
If you're small, you better be quick. Jerry Osaski, number 55, is small. But on this play, not real quick. He's got to get down. Freeman gets under into his legs, able to cut off the backside pursuit against the back like Blair Thomas. That's very dangerous. If he cuts back and you're on the ground, he's gone.
Kisner in the first half, only 4 of 13 passing, 44 yards. Kurt Warner, DJ Dozier personified, dances up to the 39. Billy Owens and Jerry Wall have him there.
Yeah, that was a remarkable 4-yard run. He's worked for every yard there. That was remarkable. There was nothing there, and it was just quick feet.
Coaches call him a coaching dream. They say Blair is their best blocker, the hardest worker, knows what everybody's job is, came to camp that way. High school coaches told the Penn State coaches he was aware of everybody's responsibility in the field. They didn't believe him. Found out it was true. Blitz. Who else? Ezekiel Gadsden.
Coverage has been absolutely fantastic for Pitt. They're allowed. They're going man-to-man. That frees up Zeke Gadsden. Hands on, just as we showed at halftime, and the great speed, and he does not get faked out. Man-to-man coverage has been exceptional for Pittsburgh, and that's really been the key to the game. Alexander trying to get loose. No way. Richard right on him. No place to throw the ball. That's what makes the rush work.
Second and 24. His way near the 30 in the grasp of Billy Owens. Billy Owens, the senior out of Syracuse. Back in 84, his turf shoe got caught. A knee injury. He became a scream machine. Kind of a manual for surgical repair. They patched him up. But when he got back at the running back spot, he found Craig Hayward and he found Charles Gadsden and six or seven others. Everybody but Rocky Blyer had taken his running back spot, so they put him over on defense. At the tight end. He wanted the tight end Pumphrey on a fly, Instead, he goes to Blair Thomas. Humphrey stride for stride, pressure by Wall and Osaski. And it's a long incompletion.
This is exactly what I said. It's backside man coverage here. The three wides to the left. Osaski trying to pick, see that? Trying to pick up Blair Thomas, and that's the weak side of the offense. And they tried to get him, but the linebackers, both of them doing their job and being right there. Pitt's defensive secondary has been exceptional.
Chris is having a career tonight, his seventh punt. This one is a line drive. Hits at the 35, fielded there by Billy Osborne. Penalty flag is down, and so is Billy at the 30. Looks like flag day. Four of them.
It's got to be a face mask.
A 38-yard kick, a loss of four on the return. They'll spot the ball at the 29, but that's before the penalty. A conclave, as Lindsay would say.
Flipping. On the return team during the run back, it will be first down after the half the distance penalty.
Ooh. So the Panthers, who started from their own 35 to start the second half, marching backwards, lead by three.
High performance luxury sedans traditionally ask you to pay a pretty dear price. Well, that's not the Mazda way. Mazda's all new 929 has world class luxury appointments. It's amazingly quiet, solid riding, and actually outperforms those guys. Now there's less standing between you and a car this good. About $8,000 less.
A better luxury car value like this comes from our intense commitment to your total satisfaction. That's the Mazda way.
I got it!
Great ideas don't always arrive between 9 and 5, so IBM is introducing...
The boss will love this.
The smallest, lowest price personal system 2.
Distribution, of course. Why didn't you think of that?
With the power and advanced graphics to help you take care of business.
That was inspired.
Anytime.
Uh-huh. Right. I'll sleep on it.
The newest member of the IBM Personal System 2 family at your IBM authorized dealer.
ESPN's presentation of CFA football brought to you by Mazda. Bringing performance and value together. That's the Mazda way. And by IBM.
Go Lions!
Along with Kevin Kiley, I'm Jim Kelly, and welcome back to Pittsburgh. Here at Pitt Stadium, sold out once again. The 87th renewal of a rivalry that goes back to 1893. Dickerson, 6 of 19, 59 yards since the first quarter. 1 of 11, Kevin, for just 10 yards. Motion across by Stewart. Little delay. Hayward, blockers, look out. Ironhead barrels to the 20, picks up 5.5. It brings up second and a short 5. Range on the stop. Miami locked up in that tie with Virginia Tech. Again, they were a 37-point favorite. Mike Archer leading by 7 against Mississippi State. Tulane 14-0. And Wisconsin giving John Gutekunst and the Gophers all they can handle at the Dome in Minnesota. Stewart and Osborne wide to the left. Williams, top of your screen. Hayward headed there. That's first down for Pitt. Bauer on the stop and a penalty flag. You get the feeling he's going to get his 100 tonight, don't you?
Well, they're really going to him now, Jim, and I think that early in the game they did the right thing. Personal foul Penn State. They did the right thing by not going to him, and now they're ready to use him. And everybody's getting fired up, even the offensive lineman, number 77, Stepnowski, pulling. This stuff has worked very well tonight. Ooh, great block. Gifopoulos getting down. Gifopoulos left his feet. Bad mistake. You see number 34. Going right by him.
Joe's gone to the foul weather gear.
He knows enough to know that he's in a battle here. His offense will not score on any prolonged drive against this Pitt defense. He's got to get something from his defense.
Kirk and Seaman, the double tight ends, in now for Pittsburgh. Motion by Stewart. Motion on the offensive right side. I think Stepnowski pulled the helmet up.
Now you may be wondering if Dickerson, being a freshman, as we hear the penalty here.
Dead ball, illegal procedure on the offense, first and 15.
You may wonder if he can audible, if he's allowed to audible. He is not allowed to change the play, but he can change the direction based on the number of people in certain areas. He reads positioning of people, and he changes the direction, and he can change from a run to a pass. But he cannot change a play at will.
No help. Crawls to the 37. Well, Tim Brando, how are the Hurricanes doing?
Jim, the Hurricanes just scored Melvin Bratton on a one-yard run. Less than 4 minutes remaining in the game. Virginia Tech just receiving the kickoff. And right now, the Hurricanes have a 7-point lead, 20-13. But it's not over yet. Back to Jim and Kevin.
And it hasn't been easy. So will it be the Hurricanes in the Orange Bowl against the Oklahoma-Nebraska winner? On second and 15. How much time do you need? Darnell measures it, fires over the middle, at midfield. Henry Tooten. Just a great individual effort by Tooten to come back for the ball, and by Dickerson.
I think the biggest thing about this play is when he stops, Jim. When he just stops, that just shows you how calm this, look how calm he is, and the confidence he has in his own ability. When he slows down like that, he's looking. He's not going out of his mind out there. He's just looking and looking for a receiver, and that just shows you that maybe he can't handle the pressure.
Well, when he stopped, and you saw it very well on the replay, you saw Trey Bauer stop, you saw Capola stop, they stopped with him. Doesn't stop. He bangs down to the 46, and Bauer's got in there. And part of the Penn State defensive philosophy, as we talked to the coaches last night, the containment. Don't give Dickerson the corners, and that's why they're stopping when Dickerson would pull up.
Well, they did it. You're right. That's a good point, Jim, and they did stop him from getting outside. Problem was they didn't get him down.
I guess if Dickerson reminds you of anybody, it's the young man out of University of Las Vegas at Nevada, and that, of course, is Randall Cunningham, now coming into his own as a quarterback for Philadelphia. Cunningham came in a little undisciplined with the great gun. Over the middle on the fly, looking for Williams, incomplete. Wilkerson back there in the coverage. That one traveled 55 in the air, and that was all wrist.
And he's picking on a good player. Wilkerson is one of the better corners Penn State has ever had. At least he threw him high and outside where he was supposed to.
This is not a city that is easy on quarterbacks. And they've seen some great ones here, like Danny Marino. And, of course, Terry Bradshaw. Second and 10. Quick count, Dickerson. Design play and the spread out will come back the other way. Ironhead. Inside the 40 to the 37. Scott Gobb stops him there, the junior out of Pitt. One that got away. A 10-yard pickup.
Very well executed play. It's a dash right and then a screen, a quick screen back to Hayward. And then this is just a nightmare here. 275 pounds, and he can run.
Think about when you see Craig coming at you as like a bobsled out of control.
Bobsled. A mail truck.
Well, we were talking about a couple of the quarterbacks that have had great careers in the city of Pittsburgh. They've also been booed here in the Steel City. Bradshaw got off to a slower start than expected, came in with a great reputation. They booed Dan Marino. All Bradshaw did was take the Steelers to 4 Super Bowls. If he doesn't get off to a good start, he'll hear the boos too. Then there was Joe Gillum. Gillum never did quite recover.
You know, I'll tell you, the funny thing about Dickerson is he has not really played a great game. He showed flashes of what he can do, but the Pitt offense, obviously, with 3 points, has not done a great deal. And yet, people are happy, I guess, because it's 3-0, and the defense is playing well.
You saw briefly on that shot, Sal Janella, and in the hat, Larry Wonky. Now, there's Wonky. How do you feel if you're Wonky? You're not seeing any action. You back up Janella and Dickerson. I almost think that Sal Janella's a little relieved. A couple of the coaches hinted at that this week. A lot of pressure on Sal.
He was like a freshman. He only played a game or two, and I think it was one game last year. He was at a junior college. He really only played one game before his senior year, lost his eligibility when they used him late in the year, as you see Wilkerson going off. And so really, he was in there for his first year. He's a freshman almost, as Dickerson is.
Gary Wilkerson going off, the junior out of Sutherland, Virginia. Kevin Woods, the senior from Birmingham, Alabama, checks in. Number two, expect them to test that left cornerback right away?
No, I expect them to test off tackle with Greg Hayward right away. He's never been stopped on a third and one this year.
Pitt, two out of three on third down conversions here in the second half. Stewart in motion. Ironhead got the first down and maybe the touchdown. Inside the 15. Tripped up at the 9, otherwise it was 6. Willie Collins, the freshman. 27 more for Ironhead.
Reminds me of what John Riggins did in the Super Bowl on that third and short when he stepped outside. Greg Hayward, this thing's designed to go off tackle. They close it inside, a little holding there on the corner. Hayward steps outside. Seaman with the block or the hole. Watch the corner.
Watch 86.
Yeah, a little bit of holding on that corner, and Hayward knows where to go. He's heading north-south now.
Of 5, Bernier traps Dickerson.
Penn State may be the toughest team in the country inside the 20-yard line. They're a pressure defense to begin with, and they're going to pressure you double that when you get close to their goal line.
Reggie Williams checks back in, carrying the play. Offensive coordinator Mike Dickens.
The problem for a young quarterback, you have to make decisions instantly on the goal line when you get close, and Dickerson may be in trouble here. Whatever he does, he's going to have to do it quick and be right. He's calling timeout.
5:11 left to go in the third quarter. Pitt protecting a 3-0 lead, knocking on the door.
At least once in your life.
Left in the third, second, and 14. Dickerson batted down at the 5 by Pete Giftopoulos.
He never looked. I just told you about it. He has to make decisions quickly. He never looked. And Penn State will always be in the right place defensively. It's up to you to beat him.
And Pete was. Remember the Fiesta Bowl? He intercepted that Vinny Testaverde pass to preserve that 14-10 win in the national championship.
Topless playing with a broken hand, or he'd have had that ball. He has a cast on his hand. Dickerson's going to have to be better than that.
Third and 14. Two wide to the left. Dickerson throws short to the 12. He's got Michael Stewart from the same part of the country as head coach Mike Godfrey near Norwalk, Ohio. Chismar on the stop.
Again, that play serves no purpose. For him to throw that ball, better for him to run to the middle of the field and fall down. He's created a tough angle for his field goal kicker, thrown a short pass that it completed, and it was completed, is not even close to a first down. That's inexperience. He'll get over that.
But it got Van Horn away from that left hash mark, where he's a little bit snake bit. Van Horn from 44, the only scoring in the game. 4.5 left to go in the third. He missed from 24. This, a 28-yarder is up, and no good. .419 left to go. Mike Godfrey's Panthers still by 3.
Looking for a new house?
You talk about a riverboat gambler, Joe Paterno. He's just sitting on this 3-point deficit. He's 3 behind, and he's going to run Blair Thomas until he pops one.
Yeah, the Penn State offense is not a complicated offense. They run several running plays, maybe 8-9 plays, maybe a dozen passing plays, but they run the plays that they run best to perfection. They just wear you down. Again, they try that left side with Sickler and Kuzi, and Spindler, the freshman, is there. Greg Hayward, 18 carries, 102 rushes again. And Blair Thomas approaching the century mark.
77, tough yards, I'll tell you tonight.
They thought they could run at Zeke Gadsden tonight. They really did.
Zeke's got a lot of friends up there on the line to help him out.
Third and three. This will be a long incompletion because Timpson turned it outside, never went upfield, and Gadsden was putting pressure on Kisner. He couldn't see where the receiver was. Another great defensive stand by the Pitt Panthers. This may be the most underrated 6-3 team and misunderstood team in the country.
Well, defense has never been misunderstood. Their defense is excellent, and they're number four rated in the country in pass defense. Nothing wrong with that.
Klaus again slithers this one off the side of his foot. Osborne will gather it in at the 29. Look out, Billy Osborne. Oh, he bounced off one more tackle, he was gone. At the 43, the Panthers lead 3-0. 2.5 left to go, third quarter.
You don't have to look very far to find some high-performance luxury sports coupes with impressive performance credentials. You really don't have to look any farther than Mazda's all-new MX-6 GT. The turbocharged, intercooled 12-valve road machine that'll outrun those other guys. And run you anywhere from 10 to 30,000 less. A better value in high-performance luxury sports coupes comes from our intense commitment to your total satisfaction. That's the Mazda way.
Introducing the G-Shock 5200 watch from Casio. The sports watch that's ready for action with a built-in shock absorber. It's tough. So tough, this G-Shock can take a slap in the face. Not even flinch. The G-Shock 5200, just one of Casio's water-resistant sports watches. It's one tough watch to beat.
I have a saying that I really believe. Football doesn't owe me a thing, but I owe my whole life to football. I'm very proud to be a part of the College Football Hall of Fame. The hall is located in Kings Island, Ohio, some 24 miles north of Cincinnati on Interstate 71. Enjoy looking at the Hall of Fame Honors Room, the locker room, the gold medal and distinguished American awards, and the time tunnel tracing the history of the game. The College Football Hall of Fame. See it, enjoy it, remember it.
Pittsburgh 3, Penn State nothing. Just over 2.5 left in the third quarter and all of the fourth quarter in this great rivalry. Dickerson bends in with White the fullback and Ironhead the tailback. Is down at the 33. Chismar, the sophomore out of Pittsburgh, has him there. Well, did the Hurricanes score again, or Virginia Tech, did they tie things up? Timmy?
All right, Jim. Virginia Tech had a last gasp with under 2 minutes left. They had the ball at their own 26. Pass was, they couldn't move on fourth down. Miami got the ball deep in their own territory, and then Walsh to Alfredo Roberts made it 27-13. Miami, we can tell you now, that game is a final, and the Hurricanes are safe, tucked away in the orange. Back to Kevin and Jim.
So the Hurricanes of Jimmy Johnson will perhaps see orange against that Nebraska-Oklahoma winner. That's Ironhead, stopped at the 37 by Schoenwolf. All right, I asked you before, who do you like in that Oklahoma-Nebraska game? We've seen both teams.
Who do I like or who do I think will win?
Who
we
do
have
you
to
think
be careful
will,
here.
Well, I know you like both.
Yeah, they're just both of those programs are outstanding, but I think my feeling is that the Oklahoma wishbone will be too much for the Nebraska defense. High-scoring game, but I think that Oklahoma will win that game.
Well, we'll take a look at one of the great games of all time, the game of the decade, the Sooners and the Cornhuskers. Highlights, interviews, all coming up Friday night at midnight, and again Saturday morning at 10. Dickerson needs 15 on third down. Safety bounds it out to Ironhead, who's pounded at the 37-yard line. Pitt fans and coach Mike Gottfried wanted a personal foul. Gobb on the stop, the junior out of Pitt. Take a lot to punish that man. 275 pounds.
First play of that drive killed it when they went for the pass, and Penn State was in a blitz situation, were able to throw him for a loss.
Jim goes to
Rask. Oh, beautiful, beautiful spiral back to Coates up to the 12. Nowhere to go. He's down at the 13. A 51-yard punt, a 1-yard return by Coach Lavinia on the tackle. Well, we heard from Todd Santos at halftime with Tim Brando. You'll see him in action. A chance to look at the NCAA all-time leading passer. Coming up next, San Diego State and Colorado State. The Aztecs get off the bus, as Hank Stram likes to say, throwing the football. The Rams and the Aztecs, Papa and Logan, are standing by. That'll be next. From the 13. The third. What are you playing? Charades? Go ahead. You can talk.
I didn't want to.
If you see something, go ahead.
I saw that earlier. That was that trap off the motion. They tipped it last time. When they run the motion, watch the motion guy. I know they're trapping back this way. I know I'm waving my arms in front of you.
I thought you were Bert Convy on the new game show.
That's that old linebacker in me. They ran out one other time. And when they run the motion guy to the other side, they're trying to break that guy loose, because the motion goes with him. The defense takes it to the other side of the field. There's no backup people if they break the trap. Yeah, I decided to lose my mind and I want to go out and make the tackle.
Hollywood Squares, Kevin Conley to block. Second and 5. Right up the middle. Borowski, super sophomore out of Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. Stopped by the great freshman, Spindler.
I'll tell you another play I'd be looking for. The drop pass by Pomfret, the tight end. If they replace him, I think that they'll probably run that same action and try and get loose. I'm sure Joe Paterno's saving that play for the fourth quarter, because 7 points will win this game. Pomfret dropped it. He'll probably put in a receiver who can catch it a little better and send him up the middle.
Well, Pomfret came into the game, 12 catches, 110 yards, for a 9.2 average and one touchdown, hampered by a pulled hamstring back in the spring, and a whistle on third and one. Third quarter has expired. Penn State trailing Pitt 3-0. Jeff Van Horn, a 44-yard field goal, and that's been it.
Introducing the Mazda way of offering a warranty.
It's the Mazda bumper-to-bumper warranty. It's not like those 5-, 6-, 7-year warranties that stop right here, powertrain only. Mazda's new bumper-to-bumper warranty takes care of you for 36 months or 50,000 miles on every car and truck. Sure, others have their way, but a bumper-to-bumper warranty is the Mazda way.
Becoming an American Express card member is now as simple as picking up one of these. Because now you can apply for membership over the phone. Membership has its privileges. To apply, call 1-800-THE-CARD.
My father is the greatest person I know.
If you had a race with my father, he'd always let you win at the end.
I love my pop very much.
He still calls me up and says, "How's my boy?"
When I grow up, I want to be like my dad.
When was the last time you took a picture of your dad?
Millions of miles.
Every year, people like racing champion Big Daddy Don Garlitz rely on the protection and quality of Kendall Motor Oil.
Don Garlitz and Kendall Motor Oil, year after year.
Kendall, protection worth its weight in gold for more than 100 years.
Waiter,
don't just ask for a light beer.
Give me a light.
Ah! Ask them to bring out their best.
Bud Light.
Bud Light, the less filling light beer with the first name and taste. Because everything else is just a light.
Okay, let's see what you got. Cocktail weenies. Now, alfalfa sprouts.
Looks like wimp food to me. Where's the starting lineup?
You, Chunky, get over here.
Nothing takes care of a mean appetite like the hearty chunks of beef and garden vegetables in Campbell's Chunky Sirloin Burger Soup.
That better not be the last of the chunky.
Campbell's Chunky. It takes care of the meanest appetites.
Along with Kevin Kiley, I'm Jim Kelly, and welcome back to Pittsburgh. The Panthers leading the Nittany Lions 3-0, with 15 minutes left to go in one of the great rivalries in college football. Wide to the left, Michael Alexander. Michael Timpson in motion. Got the first down, it was all by himself. Billy Owens hanging on while they unpile. Storyline, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. It started off with Jeff Van Horn's 44-yard field goal. He has missed from 24 and 29. Hayward again over 100 yards rushing for Ironhead. Penn State just 80 yards rushing, and Blair Thomas is the seventh leading rusher in the country. And Gary Richard with a blocked 21-yard field goal that would have tied up the game. So Chris Klaus in to punt yet again. This one hangs up high, doesn't turn over. Osborne backs up to the 34 and gets a 6-yard return. The Panthers will start from 40 yards away. All right, the 21-yard field goal try that Gary Richard blocked, here it is.
Fumbled snap to begin with. It was late, maybe the steps a little bit, but Richard coming from the outside, which is where you like to block him from, cut that guy on the corner, come down flat. He made the play, and that's been a big play because that's as close as Penn State could get all night.
14-16 left to go. Gary Richard, the senior out of Denver, Colorado. The ball in the center of the field, just shy of the 40-yard line. Dickerson bends in. Seaman and Kirk, the double tight end. Michael Stewart motions across. Ironhead motions back to the line of scrimmage and is stopped there by Polamalu and by Chismar.
Well, this is where you got a guy like Hayward. He can really help you. They're going to run a trap. Polamalu is able to fill on the inside, laying on the ground, and he makes the tackle anyway. It's a pretty good play. Team defense by Penn State. Now, Hayward is really going to help Pitt now if they want to control the ball. They've got the horse, and he should be pretty well rested.
We have not called number 99's number much tonight. Polamalu, handled by Ed Miller, the senior out of Kenilworth, New Jersey, neutralized pretty effectively. Darnell, nobody to throw to. Bumped out of bounds after a short gain of one. Third and nine coming up. Pete Giftopoulos, the senior out of Hamilton, Ontario, chased Darnell Dickerson down.
They've done a great job of containing him on the run. Giftopoulos getting all the way outside. It was a tremendous block by Prentice Wright on Bernier at the corner that let him get outside, but the inside pursuit was there.
Joe Paterno says of Giftopoulos that he has great feel for pass defense, great anticipation. The freshman, that's been the man they have worked over when they need big yardage. A 21-yard pickup.
This is just a tremendous pass. Straight drop back, no pressure. It's a zone defense. Thomas is not that far off of Tootin. Just a perfect pass.
Tootin, Proposition 48 last year, a wide receiver and safety in high school, led the state of New Jersey in interceptions with 12. First and 10 for Pitt. There's the flea flicker. Ironhead back to Dickerson, but no wide receiver is out there. Reggie Williams will have to go into the chemistry lab to catch that one. He's 10 yards beyond the end zone.
A tribute to the Penn State defense, but the reason this doesn't work is because the receivers really didn't sell it. They have to make it look like they're going to block, and they don't. You've got pass blocking. So your inside backers, if you're reading alignment, you read pass, and then of course down we go, and this thing, of course, is long gone by the time he catches it. The receiver has to make it look like it was a block. They ran a pattern instead.
Darnell said, "Wait a minute, that's not how it worked in practice." Here comes Hayward. You're hurting the collision up here. He met Pete Giftopoulos at the 37-yard line. When they were done, they were both down at the 35. We said that you could hear it. You listen in. Pursuit. He throws it incomplete. Osborne in the direction. One of the things that Dickerson's scrambling does is wear down his offensive linemen. He'll go east-west a couple times, did in his very first start. Finally, Rickett said, I was going to tackle him myself.
He's also wearing down the defense, too, Jim, on this. And he's been scrambling around a lot tonight.
Rasp, he's punted six times tonight, his longest for 51 yards. And Jim Coates is back in, standing at his own 10-yard line. Let's see how Rasp can do. Off the side of his foot, nails this one inside the 15. Well, now he keeps moving up to the 20, the 22. So the fans here in Pittsburgh don't like the spot. Penn State just one play away, and they've got a lot of time left to do it.
If you need a used car or truck, it's a buyer's bonanza at Sheehy Ford in Wilmington. Special purchase low mileage 85 LTDs with air, automatic, and more starting at $49.98 delivered. 85 Tempos, same equipment, from just $39.98 delivered. Choose from over 50 hard-to-find used trucks in our truck center. Or buy any new 88 Ford and we'll give you a vacation to Florida. It's worth a trip to Sheehy Ford Auto Center, Kirkwood Highway, and the Sheehy Ford Truck Center, Kirkwood Highway and Route 41.
These days,
ooh,
burger bundles, chicken McNuggets, teeny tenders, many mouthfuls, itchy bitchies. Hey, wait a minute, I'm a guy, not a rabbit.
I want beef, lots of beef, hee-high.
Arby's new giant roast beef sandwich, made with lots and lots of delicious slow-roasted roast beef, piled high on a really big sesame seed roll.
Arby's new giant, it's a giant sandwich, yeah. A giant kind of guy.
Three-nothing Pitt over Penn State, and ESPN's presentation of CFA football is being brought to you by Jeep. There's a feeling you can get only in a Jeep. And by the U.S. Army. Learn how to get an edge on life. Be all you can be. Stan Clayton, the senior out of Cherry Hill, New Jersey, checks in at the tackle spot for Penn State. Nittany Lions. They need three for the tie. Down for the win. Kisner, dancing feet, and he just throws this one out of bounds. Pittsburgh fans saying, wait a minute, how about intentional grounding? Well, how are the Tigers of LSU and Mike Archer doing? Let's go back to the studio and check in with Tim.
All right, Jim, late in the third quarter, LSU up 24-14. Mississippi State on the one, fourth and goal. Hank Phillips had rushed for over 100 yards, but he's stumped by Ron Sancho, Darren Marlborough, and the rest of the front forward wall. The Tigers clinging to a 10-point lead in the fourth quarter.
Jimmy, I'm telling you, they're going to the Citrus Bowl. They'll beat Penn State. A little hitch delay to Blair Thomas, who cracks it up near the 25. Osaski has him there. Jerry Osaski, the middle linebacker, has been all over the field tonight for the Pitt Panthers.
We've been telling you all night about this defense and why they can't run against it. Take a look at this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 players within a yard of the line of scrimmage. They've got more players on defense than on offense on the line, and there's just too many guys to block. And it's been like that all night. Penn State has not been able to pass, so they've not gotten out of it.
Big third and 7 coming up here from the 24. Alexander to the left, Timpson to the right. Back to Borowski and Thomas are split. Kisner backpedals, looks to the sideline, fires. Is it caught? It is incomplete at the 37. Alexander thought he came up with a catch. Richard was back there on the coverage.
He made his cut too close to the sideline. Number 9, too close to the sideline, and then never did catch the ball. Maybe interference there.
Looked as if Richard got the arm around the intended receiver long before the ball got there. Osborne is back deep. Klaus, a approaching double digits in the punting department, as this one go out of bounds at midfield. Let's take another look and see if Gary Richard did indeed bother the intended receiver, Michael Alexander. Right there, the arm's on him.
Oh, no, his face is on him, no question.
But no flag. The Panthers with a 3-0 lead have the ball and 11 minutes to go.
Go over Jeep Cherokee's advantages and certain things stand out. Cherokee gives you a choice of two or four doors, two shift-on-the-fly four-wheel drive systems, and an optional 4-liter six-cylinder engine that's more powerful, far more powerful than anything in its class. But perhaps Cherokee's single biggest advantage is the simple fact that it's a Jeep.
You know, there are a lot of places where you can look for an auto part, but here's where you'll find it. NAPA has parts for imports and other hard-to-find parts. So come to NAPA first. We've got your part.
Your neighborhood NAPA Auto Parts store has more than 125,000 parts for the typical American car. Whatever that is.
Saturday, a big interstate rivalry between two bowl-bound teams. Clemson against South Carolina. Then the Air Force takes on Hawaii. Live Saturday night on ESPN.
This series has been sold out in Pittsburgh since 1973, when they started playing for about 3 years at Three Rivers Stadium, home of the Steelers. Since then, it's come back here on the Pitt campus. Cannot beg, borrow, or steal a ticket. Another sellout crowd. Dickerson from his just shy of midfield. Hosea Hurd motion. And Ironhead chopped down after a pickup of two. Second down and 8. We talked at the top about the rivalry and the cut of the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania as far as recruiting. Also at stake, national ranking and bowl bid. Certainly for that man, Mike Gottfried. His first goal when he took over at Pitt, a winning program. Then to get to a bowl game. Then to get into the top 20. And then to get into the top 10. All those goals definitely in sight right now. And of course, hanging on here and upsetting Penn State would be a major step. Seaman and Kirk, double tight end, play action fake. Dickerson in trouble, runs away, throws it up, incomplete at the 37-yard line, and it's caught. It is caught at the 32-yard line. Osborne came from nowhere. He wasn't the intended receiver. Dickerson, watch Karpinski chasing Dickerson, who just put the ball up, and Osborne wasn't even the intended receiver coming.
Well, Jim, this is an ill-advised pass at best. Dickerson running for his life, throws it into coverage.
It's deflected off Seaman.
And Osborne catches it. That's a play that they'll laugh about on Monday if they win. If they don't, there'll be some pretty sad faces. He should not have thrown that ball.
The 27-yard line. But let's go back to what you were talking about, the story where Dickerson makes mistakes but something good happens. Gottfried talked about that at practice the other day.
If he does 4 years of that, they're going to be in trouble. That particular play, I think what they're referring to when they say that is that his athletic ability will get him out of it. That was a fluke. I'd like to make a point about counters. Their counters are killing Penn State because Penn State's defense is so aggressive, they're catching angles on it.
23 carries, 114 yards for Ironhead. 9.5 left. Hit 3, Penn State nothing. And number 34 explodes the other way inside the 20. Upended at the 17 by Trey Bauer. Blocking on that right side by Ed Miller, who's done a terrific job. 61 at center. Stepnowski, 77, and Matuz, 62. Watch him.
Before his injury, Stepnowski, 77, considered one of the best in the country. Helped with Matuz there, number 62. A great job by the offensive line. Stepnowski's had a rough year, but his ankle with that brace on it, he seems to be playing very well, and they're starting to overpower Penn State.
Ed Miller just completely neutralizing Polamalu, the nose tackle for Penn State. From the 17, first and 10. Hayward hammers over the left side. inside the 10. Ricketts, Caliguire, and Miller. Range made the stop.
The first bad thing that happens to you at the end of a game defensively is you can't finish the tackle. You can get there, you can make the hit, but you just don't have the strength. Again, Stepnowski sealing it off. You see how guys missing? That was Karpinski missing on Hayward. You just can't get there. Your legs are not good enough to stay under you, and you can't make the tackle. And when you're going against a guy 270, that's a big factor.
About a half a yard shy. Kurt Bernier on the stop.
The reason the counters are so tough is because Penn State's defense plays upfield. They're a penetrating defense. That means they want to go forward first. And when they run counters like that, you go forward and you get blocked from the side. We've had a couple of really good shots of these guys blocking down on people, and it's just murder. If you're playing defense, this is what the counter looks like. Now, Polamalu, he's not seeing anything. But see how they're... See that? See Bernier on the ground, and they're just cutting people off. They did a pretty good job on that, but it creates angle.
They say that Ironhead fell forward for the first down after the spot. Panthers got a break there. First and goal from the 7.
Excuse me, Jim.
8-12 left.
There's a gut check here for Penn State's defense now. They'll play gap. And they'll come hard.
Almost unbelievable the job the Pitt defense has done in the second half, holding within the Lions for just that one first down. Penn State has to keep the Panthers out of the end zone. Field goal, and Penn State could still win. Ironhead hammered backward for a loss of 1 second and goal coming up from the 8. Bernier on the stop once again, number 41, the senior out of State College, so they didn't have to go very far to recruit him. He was a walk-on back in 83. MVP of State College High School. Wrestled and boxed for the Little Lions there. One of four brothers and three sisters. His dad an architect at State College.
Penn State players say they like to play goal line defense because there's no question what they have to do. Again, Dickerson's got to make quick decisions because Penn State's going to be on him in a second.
Dickerson was going to run the whole way at the line of scrimmage. No gain. Karpinski on a stop. Again, Karpinski had that big Fiesta Bowl chasing Vinny Testaverde around.
This is really where you see the coaching. They have no doubt, Penn State doesn't, about what they're supposed to do. They make instant decisions. They see Dickerson, and they all come to the outside. They're forcing the ball from the inside out and then pursuing it. And Pitt has got to be able to throw the ball on the goal line. They have tried this a number of times tonight, and they have not been able to make it work.
Who do you throw to here?
You look out for a pick. I would look out for a pick on the wide receivers, try to throw a little slant in. Pick for the outside receiver.
Kurt is the tight end. He's the better receiver. Dickerson backpedals, needs 9. Only one receiver in the end zone. Dickerson needs some help. Runs out of room and throws it incomplete. Osborne, the intended receiver. Strange play call. There was only one wideout in the end zone. That was Osborne, and he's complaining that he was pass interfered against.
Well, they were all lost out there for Pitt. Here's the two receivers, both of them running similar patterns. I don't know why. Penn State all over them. And now they have to come back. Waving your arms when you're covered is not the way to do it. See all those Penn State defenders in the end zone, and nothing happening.
Van Horn has missed from 24. He's missed from 29, but he hit the only points we've got from 44. This a 26-yard try. Osborne will put it down. It's the hash mark, the left side. He doesn't like that hash mark. It's up, and it is. No good. Penn State still alive. 6:11 left to go. Nittany Lions ball when we come back. Joe Paterno unbeaten here at Pitt.
With an optional 4-liter monster under its hood, Jeep Comanche doesn't just stand apart. It stands alone.
Now, get $500 factory cash back on all new Jeep Comanches.
Palpatine, aggressor tank spotted.
In a battle drill, you need horsepower, firepower, people power. That's teamwork.
Moving tank, back front, shoot down.
This team uses a computer, thermal sight, laser rangefinder.
Yeah.
All that you can.
We win, the whole tank wins. The whole team wins, not just one person.
Find your future in the Army.
The University.
Blair Thomas has got to be getting a little bit tired for a loss of one. Zeke Gadsden. Gadsden and Osaski have simply had marvelous games. Now, earlier we talked about Osaski not being a good 50 linebacker, a 5-0 linebacker. What is it and why not?
Well, the reason is because he'd have to play in a normal alignment over an uncovered guard, and he'd have to meet that guard quite often. In a 40 front, he's the middle. He can outrun the center and go sideline to sideline. They can do a lot of stunts to protect him.
Michael Alexander bumped out at the 33 by Quentin Jones.
They've been playing man-to-man all night and making it work. Watch the top of your screen. Quentin Jones gives them a lot of room there for Alexander. Alexander breaks it off, and what they're going to try and set up probably is an out and up. Try and get the ball upfield.
Five and a half left to go. Panther fans coming alive again. Quick handoff to Borowski, the fullback. Came in with 14 carries, 54 yards, just under a four-point average. And a penalty flag yet to be checked out. Borowski's dad, by the way, Stan, played in the NFL for the New York Giants, and he also played in the NBA for the Washington Bullets. Is that right?
Dead ball, illegal procedure, on the offense, first and 15.
Wrong time for a Penn State penalty. First and 15. Five and a half left to go. Penn State shut out Pittsburgh 3-0 way back in 1911. Panthers trying to do the same here. Downfield for Timpson. He's got it at the 20. Timpson with unbelievable speed. They say he's the quickest ever at wide receiver at Penn State. A bad knee in the spring. Nothing bad here except the coverage.
They've been doing it all night. Richard's been playing him outside, giving him the inside. He gives it to Timpson here, and he just gets outrun, and a perfect pass right in his hands down to the 20. Michael Timpson, world-class speedster, and that was the difference. He caught him out there all alone with Richard and hit him.
Joe Paterno says that Timpson has more natural receiving ability than Kenny Jackson. Blair Thomas. Stop after a short pickup of one by Jerry Wall.
That's an interesting problem here for Penn State. They have not been able to run the ball with any success in terms of getting first downs. Their passing game has been weak, aside from that big play right there. And now they're in field goal range. What do you do?
Second and 9 coming up. 4:40 and counting. Alexander wide to the left. Timpson wide to the right. Backs are evened up. Thomas and Borowski. Corner looks incomplete in the end zone, looking for Michael Alexander. Richard back there on the coverage, the ball just slightly overthrown.
That was great coverage by Richard. Get right inside on the bottom of the screen. Number 9 is Alexander, and Richard, watch Richard get right inside his body there. Leaves him only one option, and that one is to go out of bounds. It's good coverage there.
How fast is Timpson? They're talking about him as perhaps an Olympic hopeful. He was the first ever to win four events in a Florida State High School track meet. He won the long jump, the 120, and the 330 hurdles, and the 220 dash.
Speed won't help him here. He's going to have to run a good pattern.
He's wide at the bottom of your screen. Batted down by who else? Number 50. 55, Osaski. Now the field goal try.
The problem here for Penn State is that they're too predictable. If they can't go to the wideouts, there's only one other guy, the leading receiver, Osaski, quick as a cat and smart, right on top of him.
Ray Taurasi, second in the place-kicking department as a freshman. Now he's a sophomore. Between the 30 and the 39, he's been perfect. This a 36-yard try in the center of the field, and you can watch. Gary Richard has blocked his second field goal try of the night. They had to have seen something on the films for him to get two in the same night.
There's no excuse for that. The man on the corner has got to take a step and make sure he gets a piece of the outside man. The outside guy, for him to block it, has got to come clean. Let's see if he steps and even tries to get a piece. Top of the screen, he steps in, gets very little piece, and Richard gets a hand on it, just a finger, just enough. Again, sealing off the inside, but not. Your responsibility is to get a piece of that outside guy. He just didn't do it, and Richard did a great job of flattening out and getting his hand out there.
We've got 4:15 left to go. We'll take timeout with Pitt protecting a 3-0 lead. 28-yard line. Was it Gary Richard or was it John Carter, number 89? Watch in the right center, lower right of your screen. Carter, 6'4", very quick for individual blockers that he goes up against, looking for weakness. He plays all four defensive line positions, and it looked like he was the one that came up with that crucial block. Down inside of four. Well, how are the Tigers doing against Mississippi State? Tim Brando?
Good news and bad news for the Bayou Bengals. Tommy Hodson hurt again, so Mickey Guidry comes in, and Wendell Davis with a spectacular catch. That would lead to a Harvey Williams touchdown. They've added a David Brown Doug field goal. LSU looking good over Mississippi State, but Hodson with a lower left back injury, and obviously that hurts the Tigers. Let's go back to Jim.
Tommy Hodson, one of the great passers in the history of the Southeastern Conference. You see our time winding down. Inside 3:45 when this play will go off. Stewart wide to the right. Lavinia and Hayward in the backfield. I bet it's Ironhead. And again, that great job by number 61, the center, Ed Miller. Trey Bauer on the stop. Ed Miller, a knee injury in 84. In fact, a lot of knee injuries have hampered his playing time. Switched from defensive tackle to center because they needed some depth at the center spot. Younger brother Scott enrolled at Pitt this fall. He's going to play on the offensive line out of Kenilworth, New Jersey. Out of Barely High School and head coach Bob Taylor. Ed Miller doing a great job, as is Ironhead. They had 37 yards in the first half. Get the ball the rest of the night. Gobb and Hayward meet head on at the 38. Well, if you're Penn State and that tenacious Nittany Lion defense, you're trying to strip the ball free.
Well, he's tough to strip the ball from because he's so big. It's all you can do to tackle a guy, much less position yourself at a point where you can strip the ball. If you go for the ball, he's gone, because you need all your body in front of him to stop him.
2:48, both teams with two timeouts, and the man you're looking at on the screen with a record of 7 wins, no losses, and 1 tie here in Pittsburgh since becoming the head coach at Penn State. This is his 38th Pitt-Penn State clash as an assistant or as a head coach. And he talked about the emotion and the excitement last night at the hotel. He said it's always something special. You get ready for this game. It's for the bragging rights of Pennsylvania. It's a big game as far as recruiting.
Well, when he came up, Jim, they would not, Pitt would not go to State College and play. They had to always come here and play the University of Pittsburgh, and I think that kind of irked the people at Penn State. And Joe says he never really forgot that. He likes to give it to him, hand it to him, but in this game he's going to need a couple of points here to win it.
Greg Papa and Dave Logan will bring you that game. Colorado State and San Diego State. Don't forget, you'll see Todd Santos He is the best passer in the NCAA. Broke that record last week. And you heard from Todd with Tim Brando at halftime earlier tonight. Third and six. A big defensive play right here for the Nittany Lions. Ironhead. First down. That'll keep the down and the clock moving. Kirkendall on the stop, but it was too late.
The right side of that line, Miller and Stefanski and Matus, double team in middle guard. And here comes the big guy. Run down from behind, and I'll tell you, third down and five or six, be able to get that. That's a pretty good block. Done a well of a job in the second half, that offensive line.
How about that? Blair Thomas, the seventh leading rusher in the country, held in check by the Pitt Panthers, Craig Hayward, running with wild and reckless abandon in the second half. Again, he only had 37 yards on eight carries in the first half. The Pitt offensive line has done its job. Ironhead dives to the 50. Second and eight. But 2:14, 2:13, 2:12 and counting. That'll be tough to pick the player of the game. On offense, no question. Ironhead on defense. You could go to Gadsden. You could go to Osaski.
Two corners.
2:12 left to go. Penn State takes timeout, so we will too. Pitt leads by three.
Jeep designed Cherokee to give you more than any other vehicle of its kind. Like a choice of two or four doors. Room for five adults. And now you can get Cherokee with an optional 4-liter six-cylinder engine that has more power, a lot more power than anything in its class. But Cherokee's biggest advantage is one that can't be measured by mere numbers. Cherokee is all Jeep.
Don't just ask for a light beer.
Give me a light.
Ask them to bring out their best.
Bud Light.
Bud Light. The less filling light beer with the first name and taste. As everything else.
The dining car.
It's just a light.
A lot of people are really going to feel the cold this winter. So add an extra layer of Owens Corning pink insulation. Owens Corning. We put your house in the pink.
On the Pittsburgh sideline, Mike Godfrey, 11-8-1 in his second year as the head coach here at Pitt, absorbed a 34-14 shellacking at the hands of Penn State last year. Now, 125 seconds away from upsetting Penn State. And for Mike Godfrey to the Panthers, perhaps a better bowl bid. Dickerson dumped at the 45 in the grasp of Brian Chismar.
Dickerson doing a little something that he shouldn't be doing against an experienced defense, especially one that has four senior linebackers. Watch him carry the ball out. And he doesn't really tuck it in when he gets hit. Still got it out. And if there's a little help coming from behind a little earlier, they can knock that ball loose. You'll hear about that on Monday, too.
The last time that the Panthers shut out Penn State was back in 55 by that 20-6 score. Third and 13. They'll keep it on the ground. Ironhead. They'll keep the clock winding down to Scott Gobb on the tackle. 123, 122, and Penn State asks for their timeout. That is the last timeout for the Nittany Lions, so they'll get the ball back. And this game is far from over when that man is the head coach. Don't forget, on Sundays, ESPN is your source for pregame analysis and postgame reflection on all the National Football League action at 11:30 Eastern Time. Chris Berman, Pete Axelm, and Tom Jackson on NFL Game Day, a one-hour preview of all the day's games. Then at 7 o'clock, Chris, Pete, and Tom come right back for NFL Primetime. Right before our 8 o'clock kickoff, and tomorrow night, the Chargers, 7-1, leading the West, playing host to the L.A. Raiders. The Black and Silver come in with Mike Patrick, Roy Firestone, and guest analyst John Matusak. Strategy time for both benches.
Penn State has got to come after this punt. Their offense, I don't think, is capable of going 80 yards. If they kick it in the end zone, Pitt, they'll have to go 80 yards. So Penn State's got to come after the punt, give themselves a chance at a field goal to tie or a touchdown to win. And what they're talking about on the Pittsburgh sideline is they'll probably go to a tight punt formation. Penn State almost blocked a punt earlier.
Yeah, it was Schoenwolf who came crashing in.
Actually overran the punt, I think. And I believe they'll go to a tight punt formation, protect the punter, and just get the ball out of there.
Coates is back deep. And Rask, who chose Pitt over Duke. Big punt coming up here. Snap is a little high. He pulls it down. Quick foot bangs the release. Coates fields at the 20 and wants the return to the 25. So the Panthers are 75 yards away from the Pitt end zone. But they only need to go about 45 or 50 yards to get into field goal range. A 33-yard kick, a 6-yard return. And here comes Matt Kisner. Senior bobbled the ball at the 37, right in front of Mike Gottfried and the Pitt coaching staff.
It's another two-man pattern. Penn State going with another two-man pattern with a minute 10 to go. Look out for the tight end or a wing back up the middle.
Again, we remind you what the Penn State coaches told us last night. Their passing game only about 50% efficient of where they would like to be at this point of the year. Incomplete at the 40 and no flag. Richard back defensively. Looked like he might have arrived a second early. Gadsden with pressure. Watch Zeke.
Well, here's where Penn State doesn't want to be. Blair Thomas not even a threat to Ezekiel coming in here. And now the pass and whether or not it was interference.
Oh, boy, that's close.
If it's not, it's the best defensive play I've ever seen.
Whoa!
Or something like that.
Third and 10. The ball game hangs in the balance. Motion by Timpson. Blitz is on. They're all coming. Matt unloads, incomplete, but a penalty flag is down. Penalty flag is down. Quentin Jones is screaming at one of the officials, and it's against Pittsburgh. Mike says, everybody stay calm. He wasn't calm after the Navy game. Told his wife, Mickey.
Top middle of your screen. Right there. Ball had already been thrown. Ball.
Was it a catchable ball?
If he hadn't chucked him,
might have been.
Yeah.
10 penalties against Pitt for 96 yards. At their bench trying to get the crowd to come alive.
Yeah, I got to believe that Penn State has a play that we haven't seen. We've only seen about 8 or 9 of them the entire night. I got to believe that they've got something here that they're saving. 39.
Field goal. Jones stayed at home. This one was never close. Alexander, the intended receiver. I want to go back to what we talked about, the passing game, as you look at that shot of the senior quarterback, Matt Kisner. When we say that the passing game is only at 50% efficiency, it's not all Matt's fault. He's got some inexperienced receivers. Sometimes
to set up the defense so they can run routes.
Matt has gone incomplete on his last 5, 2nd and 10. Throws underneath, too high, incomplete at the 45, and no flags. Jones was back on the Panthers showing blitz. Everybody's up there but the secondary. Roberts pulls it down. We'll try to run for 5, for 6, for 7. 4th and 3 coming up. Jerry Wall chased him out of bounds. Kisner in trouble, flares it out. And he's got Borowski. Borowski with a first down. Borowski down at the no timeouts left. 32 ticks left on the clock. Intercepted by the Pitt Panthers. Billy Owens. Billy Owens will score. A 70-yard interception.